All right. Hello, everybody. Welcome to episode 14, Clockwork Cantina. I'm one of your hosts, Josh Nino. Good buddy.
I'm your other host, DT3. How are we doing, everybody? This is episode 14.
14. We've made 14 episodes.
Yes.
Hi, everybody. Excuse me while I get me a drink here.
How are you all doing today? Hope you're having a good Saturday. Hope you had a good, not only week, hope you're going to have a good weekend as well. I'm excited. There's a lot to talk about today.
And we got like a bunch of news, so buckle up.
We got like 2 weeks worth of news and stuff, so yeah, it'll be.
So, excuse me.
It's going to be fun, man.
I was having a little nap before we got started here. So.
All good, man.
But yeah, let's get started with what we've been up to, I guess, because we skipped last week.
Yeah.
I took a day, which, talk about
you
that
know,
for a second.
I think,
sometimes just, you need a...
Yeah, sometimes I think you need one every once in a while. Sure.
Yeah. Some days we wake up, you just don't feel good. You need a day, man. That's okay to take that day, so.
For sure, exactly.
If you're out there and you need a day, you take it.
Take your day.
All right. But what you been up to this past week and 2 weeks, I guess, because we talk about what we did last week. If you want.
Let's see. Well, I'm trying to remember what I did last week. I don't remember. I don't even remember some shit that happened like a few days ago, man. Again, just been making more progress with my stream game, which is Shadow of Mordor. Middle-earth. Shadow of Mordor. We're getting close to the end of that game, I think, because I've been doing a lot of I got to the point where I can like turn the captains against each other and stuff, and that's fun to do, to fuck with the nemesis system and whatnot. That's great. Yeah.
One of my favorite things in gaming is the nemesis system from Shadows.
It's a blast just fucking with Sauron's army like that. And then like TV show wise, I. Caught up on DuckTales, caught up on I finally finished Krypton, which is a show that I've been watching and I hadn't finished it, and I finally did. And then I started this new show called Demon Slayer, which is an anime. And I've been having fun with that, man. It's the art style is really beautiful. It's like the most like striking thing to me. Like the thing that stands out the most is the art style. They have a lot of like beautiful imagery and shots and scenery and stuff in that. And it's really fucking cool, man. But yeah, basically, it's, as you would imagine, it has to do with demon slaying. With a name like Demon Slayer, yeah. But it's fun, man. I really liking it so far. I'm like, I'm on episode 16, and there's like 23 or 24 episodes out right now, so.
Cool.
I only just started it several days ago, and I'm already like, I've been watching like 5 episodes a night or some shit. It's great, man. That's the good thing about anime, though, or like shorter like animation stuff like that, is that they're such short episodes that you can like just fly by through them, you know?
Yeah, man.
Yeah. And then also another thing is that we finally beat Borderlands 2, man.
Yeah, we did. We beat Borderlands 2 last night.
Yeah, dude. So fuck
and
yeah,
I
man.
And I may have pulled the trigger and bought Borderlands 3.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Dang, nice, man. That's cool.
I was like, you know what? Fuck it. So
yeah, dude.
That might be happening after this.
Yeah, if you want it, Cantina. Fucking get it, right?
Yeah, so that might be live after Cantina if you guys stick around.
Hell yeah,
and
dude.
I'll put the extension on and I'll let all that cool stuff happen.
The extension stuff got you, huh?
Yeah, I thought that was really cool, man. So
yeah, no, it's cool. I was watching who else stream? I was watching another stream.
I was watching Co today. I watched Goth this morning because I didn't sleep really well, so ended up getting up. So and Goth. Gathalion, King Gathalion was on, and I was like, you know what, I'm gonna watch Goth play a little bit, and I won, like, the extension, I won a copy of his loot, which was, like, a level 40-something sniper rifle that I won't be able to use for a very long time.
So, right. Well, at least you got it, right? You got something to look forward to.
But I think the extension stuff's really cool, and, like, yeah, I think it's really cool. I know something else you watched, but I don't know if you. I don't think we've been on the podcast since you watched it, which was Karate
what?
Kid. The Karate Kid.
Cobra Kai. Yes.
Cobra Kai,
yes.
Yeah.
I've seen Cobra. See, it's been so long, dude. I've like, cause I like got through it within a,
Well,
several
you know,
days.
I won't forget Cobra Kai. I'm a big fan of that show.
Okay, so since I guess this is the last podcast, I have seen all of season one of Cobra Kai, and it's fucking awesome, dude. I really really enjoy that show.
I thought you would.
I figured I would like it, but I didn't anticipate myself liking it as much as I did,
It sneaks up
which
on you.
it's good, man. It's really really good. And then they leave off with that cliffhanger on season one. I'm like, yo, this is
Yeah.
cool, man.
We can talk about that a little bit in the second half if you want, if we
Yeah,
have time.
for sure. But yeah, it's a good show, man. I really
I'm a
enjoyed
big
it.
fan of that show, and
I'm looking forward to checking out season two as well. I know it's out already, but I just have to, see how I can, when I get to that and whatnot. But
You
yeah,
got
man,
time.
it's th yeah, there's it's great, man. Also, I've been rewatching like movies and stuff too. Like, as you guys know, our main topic is the Godzilla and the MonsterVerse. I rewatched all of the MonsterVerse movies,
Really?
meaning Godzilla 2014, Kong Skull Island, and then this new Godzilla movie. So I rewatched all of them since we were going to be talking about the new Godzilla movie. So we can get into that a little bit more as well, since I recently rewatched all of them
Fuck yeah.
and watched Godzilla, the new one, for the first time. So
Let's see, what have I been up to? But we did the Borderlands. Or do you have anything
yeah.
else?
No. I've talked enough. You go ahead,
Okay.
man.
So we did the Borderlands. I've been watching Breaking Bad on Netflix. It's the first time I've ever
Heck
watched that show.
yeah, Breaking Bad. Yeah,
It's
man.
really good. It's really good. I
You're
really
on
enjoy it.
season four, you said,
Yeah,
right?
I'm on season four. I'm on like episode, I don't even know which episode. Like halfway through, I want to say.
Right.
Breaking Bad's really good. I really enjoy it. I think I may have liked it more if I had watched it if I hadn't waited so long.
Okay. I mean it is a show from like 2008, so certain things I
Got
can
well,
understand.
yeah,
Yeah.
well, just certain things get spoiled too, like over time.
Well, yeah, that's true. Yeah.
Yeah, but
Right,
I
right,
like all the characters except Skyler. I hate her.
right. Right, like everybody else.
I despise her.
Fucking Skyler,
And I love Hank, and I love Saul, and I am going to try Better Call Saul after I get done with the
yeah. Cool, man. Yeah, but
show.
I enjoy Better Call Saul, yeah.
Because from the moment that Saul Goodman showed up, I was like, oh, I see why he's got his own show now. I understand.
Yeah.
Like,
Saul
he's.
Good, man.
Yeah. I was like, I see. I used to think, really? They made a show off this minor character, and then I was like, no, okay.
Nah, man. He
I
yeah,
get it. I get
he's
it now.
yeah, dude. He's great, dude. Yeah.
What else have I? I've been rewatching some movies. I rewatched Indiana Jones and stuff like that.
Oh, nice. Yeah, cool.
Oh, I also started watching that Unabomber show.
Oh. That's like on Netflix or
Yeah,
something?
I watched a couple episodes of it. Cause after Criminal, that's almost a
Mindhunter?
Criminal Mind, almost a Criminal Minds,
Mindhunter's you're talking about, right? Yeah, yeah,
Mindhunters.
yeah.
Yes, I was like, you know what? I'm still kind of in the mood for some stuff like that. So I watched the started watching a few episodes of that, and that's pretty good. It's got oh my God, what's his name? I just said it last night.
I just saw it last night. What the hell, man?
No, I said the name, or because I talked to Bob about it. Wow, my brain's not working. Hang on.
Unabomber, huh?
It's got fucking I'm pulling up what he's in. Sam Worthington. Oh my Jesus. Sam Worthington.
Oh,
And
right.
Paul Bettany's also in it as I keep leaving. Oh my goodness. I'm so bad at remembering. But yeah, watch that.
Cool.
Or watched a few episodes of it, and it's pretty good. I enjoy it. I need to watch it when I'm more awake. I started watching it when I was like half asleep. I also worked on a new D&D map because I am gonna start a second game at some point, and possibly a third game because this map's huge. It's big enough to fit like two parties in if I get enough people that are interested in it. So that might actually happen. I spent like 2 days. I think it's the longest time I've spent working on a map. I spent like 2 days working on it. It is done. It is complete. Except I need to label it. But other than
Cool,
that,
cool.
it's done. It's complete. I look forward to possibly streaming more. Indeed. Sure.
Haha.
I'm getting kind of getting some player schedules and stuff. And we'll see that out.
Yeah, no, I
That's like
saw
the
that,
that's the
yeah.
hard part. Like every all the rest of it's
I'm
easy.
trying to get everybody, yeah,
And
for
speaking of
sure.
D&D, we got D&D tomorrow at 6, so come or stop by here.
Yeah, we do have D&D tomorrow, which the end of the current arc, which is very very exciting.
Yeah,
We've been
it should end completely. Everything works out.
yeah, we've been in punk ass Arkmire for too long.
You see, it's been like 3 months you guys been in
It's
that
been forever, man.
shit,
It's been
which was
forever.
never my intention at all.
I'm like, let's get the hell out of this town already. I'm sick of this place. Come on. No, but I'm excited for tomorrow's game, yeah.
It's gonna be fun. I've already got everything prepped,
Heck yeah,
so it
dude.
should be good. Should be good.
That's exciting.
Except I
Very
don't know if we're gonna
exciting.
have Aaron or not, but other than that, not a big deal.
All right.
If he's
That's
there,
fine.
he's there. If not, see.
Yeah.
But yeah, make sure to come by tomorrow and check that out. The other thing is that and we didn't get a chance to talk about this because we took the week off, is that the podcast is now in MP3 form.
Oh yeah.
It is available, guys.
People were wanting asking about it and wondering if we could have this podcast in an audio format. And it happened. So
Out there, the truth is
it
out
is
there.
we've uploaded them on a we were looking we're exploring our options, seeing what we could do and whatnot. And we ended up going with the Google Drive. So they're on the Google Drive. You can, you know,
It's just the
get them
best
that
way to
way.
do it for now. That's for free, and you don't
Yeah.
have like a lot of money to.
So it's there now. If you want to listen to it on audio format, there's a link, I believe. What's the link? I put it on my Discord. Let me see. I know Josh has one as well.
Yeah, and it'll be available. Here's the link.
Yeah,
I should really make
link.
a. I need to make a like a typebot command for it, and use the tiny URL. I put the big one in there.
I got the tiny URL. Look, this one.
And yeah, put that one in. That's the one I need.
Wait, is that the right thing? Yeah. It had like a custom thing,
Yeah, I
but
don't know why they do that. Tiny URL is weird, but yeah, it works.
yeah,
It doesn't matter.
anyway, it still works. So
I need to
that's
make a nightbot command for it, or yeah,
yeah,
but yeah, it's
it's
all there,
there.
guys. It's we
Yeah.
converted all the earlier episodes; they're all up there. So go check those out if you want to.
Check it out. They're all in MP3 format. If you'd
And
rather listen to them than watch us,
in all
it's
future
fine.
episodes should be MP3 format almost immediately after the show ends.
Yeah, like this one will like probably this will be the first one of the like immediately turned into you know,
So give me like.
MP
Give me like 30
format or
minutes
whatever.
after the show's over. Go check out the link if you want the MP3 version. It's there. It'll be there. It should be there.
Yeah.
Although I kind of want to wait because Daniel usually comes up with the titles of the episodes.
Well, I mean the title I can just send you. I already have the
Yeah,
thumbnail made for
you send me
this.
the title and I'll like just
Yeah.
because I like to keep it uniform and looking nice.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's available now, guys. We did that for you. They just want we listen to you guys, and we always want to continue to improve. So it's out there. It's out. Truth.
Yeah.
I think that's about all I got. I think it's
Yep.
time to move into some news, and we have a lot of
Time to move
news
into the news.
because we skipped a bit. So we're moving
Yeah,
into the news here,
so we
folks.
can, as always, we're gonna be starting with gaming news because our regular format is gaming, TV show, movies. That's how we usually do it. So we're gonna start with movie or gaming news.
What you
Here's
got?
something that's very interesting
Oh boy.
is on September 17th, which is a few days from now, Steam is gonna be doing updating their library. So they're gonna be having a beta coming
Thank
September 17th.
God.
I'm gonna be posting a link in the chat for those of you who are curious about that. There it is. Sorry to those of you who are listening on the Google Drive or watching on YouTube because there's no link for you. But if you just look it up, I'm sure you'll find it. It's a Steam library beta coming September 17th, which is next this upcoming Tuesday. So today's the 14th when this is recorded. And on the 17th is when the beta will be happening. It's all players will be able to opt in and try out the new features starting Tuesday, September 17th. Steam is updating their library finally, which I know several people there's a number of people who have been wanting Steam to upgrade their library. So yeah, what do you think about this?
I think it's long due.
Long overdue.
They've needed to do it for a long time, so.
Yeah, I think it looks pretty neat looking at the pictures and stuff from the link. Yeah, I think it looks pretty cool.
They've needed this. They need themes need Steam. Steam got lazy because they had the market at the top for so long, like in
Right.
terms of what they are as
And
a
now there's like a million
store and
different things.
such.
Yeah.
Yeah, now you got like things like the GOG thing and
GOG and
Epic
then there's
Games Launcher and all that stuff. So,
Yay and all this shit, yeah.
and which,
Right, yeah.
but yeah, the Steam's needed a facelift for a long time. They've used that old look for a long ass time. This should be hopefully better. See,
Yeah,
that's why they're having a
hopefully.
beta. So,
Yep.
but yeah, I think it's good. But yeah. But all I got on that, which is not very much.
Next thing I got here is for those of you who are fans of the Chrono series, like Chrono Trigger and Chrono Cross, these soundtracks have been uploaded onto Spotify.
I've always
So
meant to play those and never really got the
I
chance.
have never played these, but I know that there's people out there who like absolutely adore these games and whatnot. So yeah, they've added the soundtracks on Spotify. So if you want to check them out, they are on there, both for Chrono Trigger and Chrono Cross. So if you're into the music for those games, definitely check it out on Spotify because they are there. Within the since we last had this podcast, there's been some more. There was a Nintendo Direct, which, they talked about a bunch of stuff. And one of the things was that Banjo-Kazooie was coming out on Smash. He is out on Smash Bros. Now. I have already played as him. He's pretty cool. I like it. It's pretty, pretty interesting, pretty neat. Yeah, they said that they have like a few more, I think like two, one or two more characters on the Fighter Pass thing that they have. So then they'll wrap up with that. But that's not the end of them adding more characters to the game. They will be adding more characters to the game, but they will not be a part of the Fighter Pass, obviously. So I'll be curious to see who they're going to keep adding onto Smash because I enjoy that game and
I got
there's
some
a bunch
video
of people
playing
do.
here that
Yeah,
Daniel linked
there's
me
a
to.
video of Sakurai trying out our boy Banjo right there.
Included moves from the original.
Yeah, that's which is pretty neat. You got He's cool. He's fun to play as. Like I tried him out like I think the day of or the yeah I think it was the day of that I found out he was like on the game and I was just like, all right, well, let's try him out. And he was pretty neat. Yeah, he's fun to play as. I think he's pretty
Yeah, it was new characters for next wave con to beat each other up
Yeah, exactly, right?
with.
Yeah. Oh, by next WaveCon there'll be plenty more characters.
I
Yeah.
love some of the
Yeah.
most fun I had was us playing Smash, even though I suck at it.
Yeah, Smash is always fun though. It's a heck of a good time.
My goal was just to take one of Rop's stocks, and I did
Fucking
it.
Rob. Playing fucking annoying ass Greninja. God, she was annoying. Anyway.
We should do a podcast on Smash, to be honest, after we
We
played so
could.
much
Yeah, we could. I'd be down. I
of
mean, I've played like every incarnation of Smash. So I'd be down for that
Smash
eventually.
episode. Yeah, all right, what
Yeah,
else you got?
so something that also happened during the Nintendo Direct that has me personally super fucking excited, even though I already have owned this game a few times. Jedi Knight, Jedi
Oh,
Outcast, and Jedi
yeah.
Academy are re-releasing to fucking the Nintendo Switch and the PS4 on September 24th, which is like in a week and a few days. So I'm pretty excited about that. Like I love these games,
You
man.
think that means anything? Like, is there
I don't know because, like, as of lately or recently rather, they've been like re-releasing older Star Wars games. Like these are only like the latest part of that, but like they've done like the Bounty Hunter game, the Jango Fett one. They did that one on PS4. Like they did it like a physical thing on like the limited release thing. What is it called? The limited run or whatever.
I have no idea.
Yeah, the limited run. They released like the that game. They re-released like Shadows of the Empire. They re-released the NES Star Wars game, like the old school one. So they've been like re-releasing these old like LucasArts games, which is fucking cool, man.
Man, what if they HD-ified KOTOR, KOTOR 2?
I
Like
was
the
just gonna
double
say that.
pack?
If
Oh my
they did that,
god,
oh my
dude. I'd
lord.
lose my shit.
If they like HD like re like if they did what they're doing a Final Fantasy VII to that game,
Oh my
I
goodness.
would fucking lose my shit, bro. Because what they're doing at Final Fantasy VII, I never played Final Fantasy VII, but
Either.
looking at what they're doing to that game makes me want to play that shit,
Yeah, it
dude.
makes me want to play it too. I
That
probably
thing
would play it.
looks awesome, man. Like if
It's
they
like
did that
watching a
with,
movie, to be honest.
yeah, if they did that with KOTOR, I would. I already own KOTOR like 2, 3 times. I'd buy it again. Okay? Fucking HDify that bitch, man.
Me too.
I will buy the hell out of that.
I have more than
I'll
enough money
pre-order
invested
that
in
shit,
KOTOR.
man. Okay? Fucking KOTOR has earned my love and respect, okay?
I was thinking the other day, man, I want to play again. I might start up another run at some
Me
point.
too, man. I want to do a stream run at some point, but there's just so many games to play, man.
We should
I'll do one eventually.
we'll both play it and then we'll do a podcast on
Yes.
it.
Hell yeah.
Where we talk about
Wow.
KOTOR, and that'll be a massive spoil. That'll be a spoiler cast.
Yeah, that would be absolutely like if you guys, yeah, anyway.
If you haven't
Anyway,
played
that's.
that, what the fuck are you doing right now? Go play that shit. Heard it here first. All right, what else you got?
So yeah, Jedi Outcast, I'm super excited about that coming out soon.
Oh, that's right. We're talking about like if this been
For
anything.
the Switch and PS4, so I'm very, very excited about that.
Yeah, I could see this. I could see more of this happening. So we'll see.
Yeah, I can't wait. I'm definitely gonna be getting it,
And
depending
I'd
on
be dope if there was another like Jedi Outcast
another
Academy like announcement, like some other game.
like a new game.
Yeah.
I would love that, man.
I love those. Those games are fun. They're just, the multiplayer
Yeah,
is a blast.
like I the one that I played the most was Jedi Academy, but I still enjoyed Jedi Outcast.
The role play community, like GTA.
The role play and modding, dude, the amount of mods they have for these games is astounding.
Exactly what I'm getting at. And people want Star Wars stuff. If they came out and let people do that on PC and had role playing stuff and the modding stuff like they did in the older games, I think it'd be pretty huge and pretty gigantic on Twitch. So,
Yeah, they're kind of missing out on that stuff for sure.
I
But
mean,
yeah,
you
the other thing is
see all
that
that GTA RP stuff is huge now, so.
oh yeah, the GTA RP stuff, yeah. And another thing to transition into the next topic, you were talking about what if they brought Red Dead Redemption 2 on PC, because they would do the same thing kind of deal with that. Red Dead Redemption or Red Dead Online released a new like update called the Frontier Pursuits. Posted a link in the chat right there. They released the update, I believe, on my birthday, which was September 12th or 10th. And I have not played Red Dead Online in a very long time. I would like to get to it at I would like to get back to it at some point, but I would have to like re-download it because I uninstalled it because I had to make room for other stuff. This is a beefy game, everyone.
I've watched some streams of this new DLC stuff, and it looks like they've added a bunch to the game, which is like it was kind of what was missing was it was missing a bunch.
Yeah. Well, at first, yeah, they were missing a lot of
There was just
stuff,
nothing
but
to do. We ran out of stuff to do. It's kind
yeah,
of
so
like
they
the
added like
deal.
bounty hunting and trading and collecting and stuff like that.
And apparently, there's a bunch of stranger missions and stuff as well now. I think there's a legendary gator that's online now.
Ooh, well, dude, we're gonna have to like co-stream this or something,
Yeah,
man.
we'll go back and play some Red Dead. It'd be fun. And we'll just sit there and talk like a bunch of country idiots like we do when we play.
Dude, I'm down. I'll wear my fucking hat on stream too, man. My cowboy hat.
Yeah, but that's why we were
I
talking
have one,
about
bro.
this. This is why we're talking about the other day was like they need to bring Red Dead to fucking PC and
Yeah.
stuff and let people mod it and do the fucking role play stuff because when we play it, we just start talking like a bunch of country
You're
idiots.
all right,
Yeah,
boy.
exactly
Yeah,
right.
man.
Like whenever we play, that's what we do. So
Yeah.
it's like, man, missing out on so much potential here, man.
I'm ready to stream some Red Dead Redemption online.
Yeah,
All right.
boy.
Yeah, dude. I'm serious though with that. If you wanna like co-stream that shit at some point, just give me some time to re-download it and we'll get to it, man. Because I wanna
Yeah. Yeah, I'm
yeah,
down.
he hearing all those updates is pretty rad.
Yeah, I watched the Twitch streamer by the name of Gexy Mexican. He's really cool. I love Gassy. He's one of my favorite streamers to watch, and he was playing with some of his late shift buddies the other day, and I was watching them. They were having a good time. Made me want to play.
Heck yeah, dude, I need to get back to that.
Yeah. When we got time, we can revisit that. It's a game worth revisiting. I also have poker online
Yep.
now. But...
Yep.
But yeah. All right. What else you got, friend?
The next thing I have, which is something that when I first found out about it, I can't say that I like was completely shocked, but I was like, well, this, wow. But anyway, KFC reveals
Oh,
Colonel
God.
Sanders, the dating sim in the world. You know,
Oh,
it's
my God.
called. This is called "I Love You, Colonel Sanders," a finger licking good dating
Oh,
simulator.
my God. I don't understand
So,
this.
this is hilarious. Okay. KFC is public. They're publishing, by the way. I was checking on Steam, and they're listed as the publishers. So, I can't believe this. This is amazing. You know what, though? I have a feeling that somebody, I don't know if this is gonna be a free game or this is gonna be like a game that you have to like buy or something. I have a feeling somebody's gonna gift this to me so I can stream it on Steam.
Probably.
I already know it, dude.
All I know is when you beat the game, you better get a coupon for some free chicken.
Shit.
I told my dad about this because he loves KFC. I was like, Dad, they made a Colonel Sanders dating simulator.
Yeah, they really did. So this is a thing, man. I love you, Colonel Sanders. A finger-licking good dating simulator. That's a mouthful of a name, but you know.
I want to know why. I want to know whose idea. I want to
Yeah,
know what they
I'd be
were
curious.
on
This
that
also
day.
releases on September 24th, so
I
9
want to know
days.
who
Yeah.
went into that boardroom and was like, "You know what we should do? Fucking Colonel Sanders dating simulator." And I want to look at the guy that's like, "Fuck. He's got an idea. We should do
Yeah.
that." Like, that's what I want to. I want to know that story.
Yeah.
Because Jesus.
Exactly. It's fucking crazy, man. I'll put in the link in the chat again. It's just
Oh
I
my
can't
God.
believe it, man. It's I have a feeling I'm gonna be playing this on stream because
It's
people want
already
me
got a Steam
are gonna
page.
want me to play it. Yeah. Yeah, but look, fucking KFC is listed as the publisher.
Okay, planned release date is September. Oh, it's planned release in
Yeah,
seven
9 days,
nine
man. I'm
days.
saying, yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, it's like coming out in 9 days.
What has the developer done? Oh, they haven't done much.
So, yeah,
Oh, if you
that's, I
click on the
mean.
developer and hover over the Colonel Sanders thing, it says free.
Oh, really?
But
Oh,
I
so
guess
this is
not.
gonna be a this is gonna be a free game then.
It looks that way. I'm not gonna say 100% sure until it's actually free.
Huh. Well, in that case, the people of my stream are gonna definitely want me to play it.
I might play it just 'cause why not?
I usually play these kind of games on like Valentine's Day streams. So I'll probably do that for next year's Valentine's Day
Fucking
stream.
Colonel Sanders looks so anime.
Yeah, I mean they all do. Have you
Jeez.
seen all the screenshots for everybody?
Yeah,
It
I've been
looks they
playing.
look fucking yeah.
I like under features it has 11 herbs and spices.
Really?
Yeah. Nine lovable
Oh
characters,
yeah.
multiple hours playthrough,
That's
a
hilarious.
dateable Colonel Sanders, a secret ending, secret
Oh, a secret
recipes.
ending.
Cooking battles, battle battles, earn a degree from a fictional culinary school. 11 herbs and spices. Cute
Cute miniature
miniature
food.
food. Officially created by KFC, and then it says, no, really.
Yeah, apparently, because they are the publishers, so
yeah, that's a thing that exists that we didn't
that
know
is
we
a
needed.
that's yeah, I yeah.
We're over here like KOTOR and KFC's like, nah.
You
Fucking
want some
Colonel Sanders
finger
dating
licking
sim.
chicken?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh my
Anyway,
goodness.
that's enough silliness with that for now,
I had to
I
check what month we were in.
think. I think the last piece of gaming news that I have is Cyberpunk 2077 released a cinematic behind the scenes trailer.
Oh yeah.
I checked it out. Looks pretty neat. I put it in the chat.
Yeah. Some Tokyo Game Show got stuff came out too, and like a bunch of that stuff. Talk about
Yeah, I know you got some stuff on that.
that. Yeah. I actually didn't watch this.
You can put it up on stream if you want. Yeah.
There we go. God, I kind of want to turn sound on at the same time I don't, because...
Yeah, it's...
I just don't feel like dealing with it, man.
No, yeah, I know. I don't either. That's why it's, like, just better off not having it at all.
Yeah. I think this is something that needs to be downloaded.
For sure, yeah. It's pretty neat. You can just skim through it if you want. It's just behind... It's like a behind-the-scenes thing.
It's
on
cool,
the trailer that they did. Yeah.
I really like that trailer.
Yeah.
I'm always fascinated by, like, mocap stuff.
It's pretty dope how they do that kind of stuff.
Yeah, man.
Heck yeah. Heck yeah.
I feel like that'd be so hard, how you portray death in, like, a fucking... Like, wearing this suit with a bunch of balls on it, and I have to pretend I'm dying now. Yeah, that would be so hard.
I'm dead. Ugh. Yeah.
Yeah, and you have to make like the face movements and stuff. Man, I feel like that'd be so hard to do.
That's acting though, man. That's their you know, that's what they do, man.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, the shit. I do that shit when I play D&D, and you guys don't even see it. So. I make all sorts of movements. Anyway, that's that. So go check that out, guys. That's pretty cool.
Yep.
Listening or watching.
Yeah, and that's all I got for gaming news. I'm sure, I know you have more stuff, so that's why I'll
there's
let
just
you
a
get
bunch
to
of Tokyo
stuff.
Game Show stuff. Death Stranding has like a 40-ish minute video out there of gameplay. I haven't watched it.
I haven't seen it either.
I might watch it at some point.
I don't think I will, because I'm just not really interested in that game. But
yeah, same.
That's just me personally.
I'm just trying to figure out what it is. Final Fantasy VII has a bunch of stuff out there. They had like a cinematic trailer that's like 2 minutes 50 seconds long. They had some gameplay that's like 15 minutes.
Yeah, I heard about that. I didn't watch any of it though.
I haven't watched any of that either, but I heard it's gorgeous. But it was gorgeous at E3, so why wouldn't it be gorgeous now?
Right.
And I'm just scrolling down the news to get to hear you guys really quick, just to see if there's anything we missed. So.
I'm sure there are a few things, but...
Yeah. New Game Plus and a variety of other DLCs have released for Days Gone for free. Free of cost.
Oh, that's cool. That's another game that I need to get and stream at some point.
Yeah. I'm going to wait for sale on that one. But I'm interested in it.
For sure. Yeah, I'm interested in it as well. Sam Witwer's my boy.
Yeah.
Cool.
Oh, I played some WoW Classic. I guess I... But I've kind of lost interest in it a little bit.
Wow.
I should have talked about that. I thought I'll just throw it in here to fill time.
Yeah, it's all good. It's fine.
Wow.
If you got nothing else, we can just move on.
Watchdog right? Legion's exact map size is allegedly 6 times larger than Assassin's Creed Syndicate. Oh, that's pretty big.
Hmm.
I'm just scrolling. I'm just scrolling the. They added Anthem to EA Access. Yay. I guess.
Yeah, I mean, sure.
That's a thing.
Yeah. EA and Anthem. EA and Anthem. Yeah, I mean, if you got nothing else, we can just move on. It's fine.
I think we're gonna.
Moving on. All right, so moving on to TV show news.
TV news, that's right.
Watchmen, you know, the Watchmen series from HBO has got a release date, October 20th.
Didn't they have a trailer? I thought a trailer dropped.
They did have a trailer. That's Ooh. The other thing I was going to say. They have a release date and they have a trailer, which I'm going to put the link into the chat. Boop. So there was a trailer. I checked it out. I like the song choice. You guys will not hear it because it's not gonna be.
Yeah.
There's no audio on stream, but you should check it out on your own time.
We just don't and like to fight think, with copyright.
I think that yeah, and I think that the song choice was a good one personally. I enjoyed it. I dug it.
Yeah, I haven't watched it yet. So.
But I still don't know what the hell this show. What's going on in this show, man? Like. In general, I'm not too familiar with the Watchmen stuff.
I think this is like a sequel to the...
And then, like, I just don't know what the fuck is going on here, you know what I mean? Like, it's just, I don't know. Like, I'm still curious enough to check it out. I'm still going to watch it. But I'm just like, I don't know what the fuck is happening.
I think I get bits of it that I can kind of get together. Just from all the trailers and stuff we've seen. But,
yeah.
And based on I'm what happens like, in the comics and the movie.
Yeah, I'm just like, I don't know what the hell's going on.
Definitely gonna check this out when it comes out.
For sure, I'll be checking it out as well. It's something that, you know, HBO has to have. Now that Game of Thrones is over, they gotta pick it up with some other stuff, right?
Which HBO is usually pretty good at that.
Yeah, and they are. Because
I mean, they had like the Sopranos and stuff before GOT.
Right. Stuff like so they've always kind of been in the mix of like, you know, the higher tier stuff. But yeah.
So here's hoping this is good. It looks interesting, and we're definitely gonna check it out. It's got a great cast, and
for sure. So yeah, their release date again is October 20th. In case you guys are wondering, HBO. It's coming out next month, man. Next month. We're about a month away from this show. So that's exciting.
Yeah. Because we definitely need more to watch. God knows there ain't enough out there as it is.
Right? There's like a million one.
Caught up.
A million and one different things to watch. And then they're like, here's another show.
Dark Crystal.
Yeah, me too. I'm probably going to watch the series and then rewatch the movie afterwards.
That's so probably what I'm going to do too.
It'll be interesting to watch it that way.
I want to finish Breaking Bad.
Yeah, Breaking Bad is good stuff.
All right, what else you got?
Here's something that you'll like or that you think is good. The Toys That Made Us, Season 3, has a reveal date.
I didn't see that.
November 15th. Yeah, they tweeted it out. Look, check this out.
Really? Damn, that's still so far away.
It is, but like, you know,
I love that show.
It's about 2 months away.
It's good to like just throw it on and go to sleep to it. For me.
Yeah, man. So The Toys That Made Us, Season 3, we're getting it in 2 months. Very exciting. I love the show. It's really cool. I really dig. I know Josh digs it well, so that's why I was like, well, this is something that Josh will enjoy because we both like the show.
I'm a big fan.
2 months away from The Toys That Made Us Season 3. Very exciting. If you guys haven't checked it out, and if you're into like old school toys and stuff, then definitely give it a shot.
Yeah, they've done episodes on G.I. Joe. I even watched the Barbie episode.
They did a Barbie one, G.I. Joe, Lego, Star Wars, Transformers, Ninja Turtles, I believe.
Because the He-Man. It's so good just to learn all that stuff. I watched the G.I. Joe episode with my dad because he like had some of those old
Joes. Just seeing like the history of like, you know, the toys.
Transformers and, like, I love that episode. That one's really good.
Yeah, how they became and to, you know, all that stuff.
So in the companies and all that. Yeah.
It's really, really cool seeing all the backstory and whatnot.
Fuck yeah, dude.
Alrighty. The next thing I got here is that the Lord of the Rings Amazon show, you know, the prequel show for Lord of the Rings, has cast one of its leads. We don't know who he's playing, but Will Poulter has been cast in the Lord of the Rings Amazon show.
Boy.
Will Poulter has been in things like, you guys may know him from probably like Black Mirror, the Bandersnatch thing.
Oh, yeah, I know this guy.
Yeah, he's that guy. He was also supposed to be Pennywise the Clown in It before he got recast by the Skarsgård dude. But yeah, this guy's been in a few things. He was in like I said, he was in apparently Detroit, the movie, which I haven't seen yet, but it's the John Boyega movie. He was in that. He was in The Maze Runner, if any of you guys like that. He was in Black Mirror will probably be the most recognizable place. That's why I mentioned that first up top, because, you know, that's, like, the main thing he's been in so far, I would say.
Yeah.
But, he's going to be one of the main characters in the Lord of the Rings show, so that'll be interesting. Let's see. Oh, here we go. we're gonna head into talking about the Mandalorian here now. We have a few things in the Mandalorian. Is an actress by the name of Julia Jones, who people may know from the Twilight franchise.
Boy.
Yes, that Twilight. She's gonna be in the cast for the Mandalorian. Which I think this is cool because I think she's like Native American, I believe. I think so. So it's cool having like somebody like her in the show. So she's gonna be a part of that. And then speaking of, we're talking about the Mandalorian. I said I have a few things. The Mandalorian is gonna explore the origins of the First Order in the show.
Yeah, I heard about that.
So this is going to be pretty interesting. It would be cool to see how they tie in stuff from like the like aftermath novels, which have to deal with kind of like, you know, the aftermath of the Empire and, you know, like after, it's like after Endor, which this series Mandalorian is going to take place after Return of the Jedi. So we'll see how like, you know, the Imperial fleet that fled into the unknown regions, you know, which eventually forms like First Order and stuff. We'll see how that happen, you know, comes to fit into this.
Yeah.
Because the Mandalorian is going to be like, they said straight up, like the Mandalorian is not going to be like in the core world. It's not going to be like, you're not going to see like the New Republic and like, you know, the Empire and that kind of stuff. Well, I mean, you are going to see the Empire, the remnants, but like, you know, it's not going to be focused on that stuff. Like,
yeah,
the Mandalorian is going to be like in the Outer Rim doing his own thing.
Yeah.
It'll be interesting to see in what ways they tie that in. They tie this stuff in the First Order origins into it, but
that's
exciting though because we didn't know. We still in the movies. We don't know how the fuck the First Order became.
I'm super excited for that show.
Yeah, me too. And then also, they released some episodes or some photos for the Mandalorian, which I'll put in the chat. There's some really cool images here. There's one with the Mandalorian and Gina Carano's character, Cara Dune. And the Mandalorian's armor looks different than the stuff we've seen, which I've heard some things about, and I already know how that's going to go. But like, you'll notice that he has different armor than some of the other images. He looks fucking cool, though, man. He looks so cool. Every time I see a picture of the Mandalorian, I'm like, I can't wait to buy that Black Series in Funko Pop.
Yeah.
Because... Which, by the way, October 4th is Triple Force Friday, so that's when all the new merch for Jedi Fallen Order, for the Rise of Skywalker, and the Mandalorian comes out. And you bet your ass I'm getting the Black Series and Funko Pop of the Mandalorian.
Yeah, boy.
Because that is one bad motherfucker right there.
Yeah.
The one with him with wearing the silver armor with Cara Dune in the first shot, and then there's another one below where he's wearing his older armor. With the cape and stuff, and he's fighting Trandoshans, so that's, you know, that looks pretty rad.
Man, I bet it's fun to work on that series.
Oh, I bet it is, man. Oh, I bet it is.
Imagine just walking onto the set and you're fucking in Star Wars.
I know, right? It's so cool. And like they've been talking about how like they're doing like revolutionary stuff for like TV in this show and whatnot. So I can't wait, man. I can't honestly. I know I've said this many times, but there's nothing more that I'm excited about than this show. And I cannot wait. Cannot wait for this fucking show.
Yeah, me too.
The last thing I have on The Mandalorian is that Jon Favreau plans on directing an episode of season 2 himself. Which, as we know, they're going to be starting up production on season 2, I believe, next month. So they're already working on season 2. They're writing, they're prepping, they're getting the directors ready to direct and stuff.
Yeah,
but yeah, Jon Favreau, I don't believe directed any episodes in season 1. Like Filoni directed like 2 episodes, I think, and they had like Taika Waititi, and they had Bryce Dallas Howard and Rick Famuyiwa and like, you know, Deborah Chow and a bunch of other like really like awesome directors for season 1.
Yeah, with a lot of great names.
So yeah, Jon Favreau is looking at directing an episode. Himself.
I love Favreau, man.
Me too, man.
He's doing God's work.
Him and Dave Filoni, I trust in those two more than anyone else.
Yeah, so true.
For Star Wars right now, because they are They're killing it, man.
Should have gave them the last season in Game of Thrones.
Anyway, that's all I got for the Mandalorian. A lot of information there, a lot of good stuff. Like, again, though, I can't wait for that damn show. Like, yeah.
I'm excited.
I can't wait, man.
Yeah.
Sticking in Disney Plus news, though, the Hawkeye series is in talks with its one of its leads. As we know, Kate Bishop is the protege to Clint Barton, right?
Yeah.
As the Hawkeye. So they're targeting Hailee Steinfeld as Kate Bishop for the Hawkeye series.
And
if you guys know, if you guys don't know who Hailee Steinfeld is, she's an actress, singer. She was in Bumblebee. She was the main girl in that movie. She's in like a bunch of other stuff. She was in the I think the Pitch Perfect movies. She was
really
the little girl in True Grit. If you've seen that movie from 2010, great movie. She was the voice of Gwen Stacy in the Spider-Verse movie that just came out as well. So Hailee Steinfeld is, I think she would kill it in this movie, man, yeah. Or in this show as Kate Bishop for Hawkeye.
Yeah.
Because I loved her in Bumblebee.
Yeah, she's great in Bumblebee.
I liked her in True Grit when that came out years ago. And of course, she was awesome as the voice of Gwen Stacy. So I'm like, to me, she's done no wrong. So get her in here, cause she's gonna kill it. I think.
Bumblebee's just good. It's a good movie.
Yeah. So yeah, Hailee Steinfeld is up for Kate Bishop in the Hawkeyes.
She fit perfect in this world.
I think so.
All right.
Another thing I have is here's another show that I know you enjoy. Disenchantment Part 2 has a trailer.
Yeah. Oh, it does.
Which I linked in the chat.
Ew.
Yeah.
This is my go-to-sleep show. Kind of like Futurama used to be.
Mm-hmm.
Which makes sense.
Which, by the way, guess when the show returns? Next week, September 20th.
Right.
So soon as well. We're a week away from this show returning.
This show left on a cliffhanger. Kinda.
Yeah.
For an animated show. Yeah, as you can see there. It all.
It's coming back, though. We'll be all right.
Yeah. But yeah, I feel like it took a long time for him to make this too.
Yeah, kind of, right? Like, when did season 1 come out? Like 2 years ago or something?
It felt like forever ago. It looks like the animation's even better than it was.
Yeah, I would imagine so.
Yeah, I dig this show. It's fun.
Yeah, I like it as well.
It's like a goofy, even goofier D&D. I guess.
Yeah, that's the thing that always came to mind when I saw. I was like, this is just like straight up D&D, man.
I could easily run a game in this world, and it'd be like a comedy game.
Yeah.
I couldn't do any of the voices though. Those are really good voice actors, but. Yeah,
it's pretty neat. I'm excited. I like season 1. I had fun with it, so.
That's a long trailer.
You know, it's you know. Simpsons and Futurama. If you're like into that kind of stuff, you'll probably enjoy this.
Yeah, I have a good time with it. It's funny.
Yeah. If we're done with that,
let's
move on to other things.
I get caught up watching the video.
No, yeah, you're good. Here's something crazy. South Park has been renewed until 2022.
Hello, so buddy!
They're going to keep running for years still. This show has been going on since, like, 97, I think.
I was never a big fan of South Park, but damn.
They've been going they're going for 20 plus years, man.
What I do like are the games, and I want them to make more games, because I like watching streamers play them. RDE games. Fractured Butthole.
Yeah, it's just... It's crazy, man. And so it's been renewed until 2022, and Matt Stone and Trey Parker, of course, the main two guys from this, say they have new movie ideas as well.
When you look at the origin of that show... And then look at it now. It's insane.
I mean, yeah, I know. I've seen like some of the older like first episodes, and it's so like crazy how
Because
different
like
that
it was
was.
never like meant to be like a show. Like they did it like as like a birthday thing, right, for somebody, I believe, or something to that effect. And like somebody saw it and was like, we need a show of that. And then here we are now, and those guys are rich beyond belief, and Jesus.
Yeah, it's insane, man. It's
Really is.
pretty insane. Yeah, so they've been renewed to 2022. They have new movie ideas and whatnot. What else we got here? Oh, Game of Thrones, a second prequel is in the works at HBO. So you know how they've been working on another like spin-off show? They're working on another one now. So this one apparently might have to do more with the Targaryens or whatever. So
Yeah.
we'll see. I don't know. I'm still kind of like
Soured on it.
soured from the last season. So I'm like, I don't know. I honestly don't know when I'm gonna feel better about Game of Thrones. Like, because I do think that that last season fucking tarnished the show for me, man. Like, I just,
Yeah.
it was so good. Even season seven had a few things where I'm like, well, I don't like that necessarily either. But like season eight was just, it was like, I can't with season eight, dude. Like the first two episodes I dug and I thought were good, but then after that it just got like, anyway, I don't want to get back into that, but
No, we did a whole
no,
podcast
yeah, we did a whole thing talking about that already. You can go back and check that out. But like, yeah, I don't know when I'm gonna feel better about Game of Thrones again. Like, I still enjoy and love the earlier stuff, but man, I don't know. Hopefully, like, I think it probably won't be until like I see the trailer for the new stuff or something. I just,
Yeah, that might
because I
rekindle
don't
your
know,
love.
man. Yeah, it might. Yeah. Anyway, we'll see about that. But yeah, there were HBO is working on a few Game of Thrones spinoff shows, so we'll see what happens with that stuff.
They don't want to let that go. That's a cash cow.
Nope.
They go milk the teats of that some bitch till nothing come out no more.
The last thing I have for show news is I know you don't watch these shows anymore, but the Crisis on Infinite Earths CW crossover, six shows, five scripts, one epic Crisis on Infinite Earths.
Jeez.
So they're doing all the shows this year, man. They're doing Supergirl, Arrow, Flash, Legends, fucking Batwoman, which is a new show, and then also Black Lightning. So they're doing them all this year, man.
They're gonna do
That's gonna be
some house cleaning too,
bonkers,
apparently.
man. Yeah, that's it's gonna be nuts, dude. I can't wait. I've heard some things in casting rumors and then like stuff like that. I'm pretty excited, man. This is gonna be cool.
Yeah.
I enjoy these shows, but my issue with them is that they're too long, man.
Yeah.
There's like 20 episode seasons, and then the worst part about that is that they have like these stupid, ridiculous breaks in between. It like fucks up the rhythm and flow for me, man. Because like you have like the show every week, and then you have like this ridiculous, dumbass break in the middle of it for like no reason. And then it's like, oh, we'll be back in 3 weeks. The fuck? Huh? That's part of the reason why I stopped watching these shows like years ago. I caught up like a couple of years ago, but like there was a time where I didn't watch these anymore because the breaks just like killed it for me. I mean, I was just like, I don't, when, what?
Yeah, they.
But I'm excited, man. Like this is gonna be Arrow's last season. You know, Arrow's gonna go off. It's only gonna have 10 episodes, which I wish all these shows were like 10 episodes. That'll make them a lot better. Quality over quantity, you know. I wish that they would do that, but they love having 20 plus episode seasons, so whatever.
They should do it like Cobra Kai.
Exactly. That show was all good. I enjoyed every episode there.
I just I like the crossovers,
Yeah, the crossovers is always fun, man.
and I liked most of the shows, and then like I don't know, I would have to go back and rewatch the shit to remember what I didn't like about them that made me stop watching them, you know? And like,
Yeah,
I wasn't
I
a
think
big
you should.
fan of Alicity and all that rigmarole, and like just like there's so much
Oh, you weren't a
stuff.
fan of Alicity? Oh shit, man. They're gonna bag on you in the comments. No, I'm kidding.
I don't care. God, bring it on.
I know, right?
Like I don't like it. Get the
Anyway.
fuck over it.
Anyway, Arrow is last season. So.
Yeah.
Yeah. Cool. That's the last thing I have in TV show
I
news.
got a couple tiny things.
Alrighty, what you got?
The Wheel of Time cast has united in the first group photo, and I think it says a lot about the show. But let's read the article here. I'll post it
Go for it,
in the thing.
man. Go
So
for
for
it.
those of you that
See
don't
what you
know Wheel
got.
of Time, it's probably the next big thing after Game of Thrones book series that's getting turned to something. In my humble opinion, I tried to read.
I tried the weed.
I tried
Yeah.
the weed. I tried to read all of the books. There are a lot of Wheel of Time books, by the way, a ton of them. But though, all the cast members have already been announced, but they had a big group photos. So you got,
Was him in Pike, huh?
yeah,
Yeah.
she's playing Moiraine. Rand Althor is being played by Jascha Strzodowski. Piran Ibarra is being played by Marcus Rutherford. Matt Cawthon, I can't. I have no idea how to pronounce any of the character names, by the way.
Matt Cawthon, I guess,
Yeah,
yeah.
they're a little weird. Being played by Barney Harris
Egwene Alvere
is
by
being played
Madeline Madden.
Madden. Navi, I guess.
N Ni Ni Naya Nynaeve. Nynaeve?
Nabe,
Yes. That sounds
I
right.
say. Being
Nynaeve.
played by
Nynaeve.
Zoe Robbins
Zoe Robbins.
and Alan
Alon
Mandragoran. That's a fucking name. That's a D&D name right there. Being played
That
by
is a
Daniel Radin.
fucking These are all fucking D&D
Well,
names,
I mean,
man.
like considering it's a fantasy novel, it makes sense.
Yeah, I'm sorry, these all sound like fucking D&D names, man. Especially that last one though. Alan Mandragoran, yeah.
This cast is super diverse, and I think it's great.
It's
And
cool, man. I've never heard of this, so I don't know what, like I don't know anything about
I
it,
think
but
if you I read the book, I think you'd dig it.
okay.
I've read a few of the
I mean,
books.
I'm sure that if I once I see a trailer or something, I'll be down.
Yeah, we'll see how Amazon takes their whack at fantasy, how they do.
Cool,
But they're
cool,
doing
cool,
pretty
cool.
good right now with their other shows, so.
Yeah, they really are. I heard I've heard I love The Boys. I love The Marvelous Mrs. Maisel. I hear good things about Carnival Row, which I want to check out.
Yeah, check out Carnival Road.
So yeah, I'm interested.
Yeah, I
Keep
dig
it up,
it.
Amazon.
I dig it.
Yeah.
Another thing is, moving on from that, is that Alexander Skarsgård is going to play Randall Flagg in The Stand on CBS All Access.
Oh, I think I heard about this, yeah.
For those of you that don't know Randall Flagg, that's like the villain that Stephen King uses in all of his books. That's like fucking, I don't know how to describe. He's like a fucking agent of the devil kind of deal. He's an
Agent
evil,
of
evil
the
man.
devil.
He's even in like the Dark Tower and stuff. Oh, I already have a Nightbot command for the MP3.
There it is, yeah.
I forgot I made that. But yeah, I like Alexander Skarsgård. I like the Skarsgård in general. So, acting family.
Yeah, the scar guys are good, man. Very good.
But yeah, that's a thing. I'm just gonna double check, make sure we haven't missed anything. I don't think we have.
Coo-coo-coo.
Do-do-do-do-do-do. Stranger
Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do.
Things 3 helping fuel Netflix quarter 3 subscriber growth. I already knew that.
Oh, damn. Which, yeah, I mean, Stranger Things is one of Netflix's biggest original shows. So. And it was so good, which if you guys haven't seen it yet, go watch it. What are you doing?
I liked it. Yeah, it was good.
I love season three. It was fantastic. It was really.
I think I liked it more than.
I know I liked it more than two. I would still have season one, season three, and season two. Like, that's my order. But season three was
I think there was a Jack
great.
Ryan trailer coming. Have you watched Jack Ryan?
I haven't. It's the John Krasinski's in it, right?
Yeah, it's good. I
I haven't
watched
seen it
all
yet,
of
no.
it. I think that they got a new season coming. It's a good show. I really like it.
Cool. Cool.
I think they had a trailer or something, but I don't see it.
Right.
That might be like from last week that we missed news, or maybe we did show it and I just
Probably, I
forgot
don't
about
know.
it. My brain ain't working at 100% capacity at the moment.
That's fine. It's all good, man.
Yeah, I think that's all I got for
That's cool. We can move on to movie news.
other than everybody should go watch Rome. Because it's good. It's old,
Go
but it's
watch
good.
what?
Rome. HBO's
Rome.
Rome. I love
I
that
haven't
movie,
seen
that
that.
show.
I gotta check it out. It's another thing on my list, man,
It's you'll love it. I guarantee you
Oh,
will love
I'm sure I will. I fucking love like Spartacus and shit like that. So, you know, I'll I have a feeling I'll enjoy the shit out of that.
Yeah. We're at exactly 1 hour, by the way, of recording time.
All right. Move on to movie news.
What you got?
So this happened very, very recently. And by very, very recently, I mean like as recent as like yesterday.
5 minutes ago. Oh, no. Okay.
No.
I thought that's where you were going.
I mean, I could have, but no.
I immediately switched to new and was like, what I miss?
James Gunn tweeted out the Suicide Squad cast, a lot of people which were rumored have now been confirmed. So here's the official cast. It's David Smalshian, John Cena, Jai Courtney, Joaquin Cosio, Nathan Fillion, Joel Kinnaman is returning as Rick Flag, Mei Ling Ning, I don't know, I'm not sure who that is, Flula Borg, which is like a, I think a German comedian, so that'll be interesting, Sean Gunn, of course, because James Gunn's got to have his brother and everything, Juan Diego Boto, I'm not sure who that is either, Storm Reed, Pete Davidson, the SNL guy, Taika Waititi, Alice Braga,
everything
Steve
yeah.
Agee, another comedian guy. There's a lot of comedians in this. Tinashe, I think. Kajisi, okay. Daniela Melchior, which she was rumored. Peter Capaldi, which was rumored. Julio Ruiz. Again, not sure who some of these guys are, but Jennifer Holland's in this. Viola Davis returning as Amanda Waller. Idris Elba, new to the cast. Margot Robbie returning as Harley. And Michael Rooker rounding us out. So Jeez. Of all these names, who's got you excited for this?
John Cena, I'll be honest.
John Cena?
Yeah, I think he's great. Yeah, John Cena. Although I love Idris Elba, too.
Yeah.
There's a lot of good names in there, but I'm,
it's actually a heck of a cast, man.
I wonder who John Cena's playing.
Yeah, I'd be curious, man.
Last thing I saw him in was Bumblebee, other than wrestling stuff. So.
Oh, right. Yeah. He was a Bumblebee.
He's a Bumblebee. I think
he was not bad in there. I didn't mind him in that movie.
He's a pretty good actor. Like,
I didn't mind him in that, yeah. What else was I gonna say? Also, I noticed in this cast list somebody who's not returning. Fucking Jared Leto is not returning as a Joker.
Hey, I think that Joker is gone forever.
I know, but I've been seeing people out there that are like, where's Jared Leto and stuff. So there's people out there who liked his Joker. I was kind of like, on this Joker.
It was an interesting.
It was different.
It
was
different.
It's not my favorite Joker. That's for sure. I'm more excited about Joaquin Phoenix's Joker coming out here.
I don't know if
which,
I can
by the way,
Joker.
that'll lead us into our next topic. Joker movie has been getting some extremely high praise, man. I'm gonna link you an Instagram post here from a week ago with the director Todd Phillips has a poster. And just look at that, man. There's been like it's been winning like awards at like the fucking film festivals and shit, man. This movie is like people are saying like it could be an Oscar contender, man. Like the movie, maybe the directing, Joaquin Phoenix will probably get nominated for like, you know, leading actor or whatever.
Yeah, it looks
like this movie is getting some extremely high praise, man. I'm very, very excited.
I love Joaquin, man. He's a hell of an actor.
He's gonna kill it, man. I have a feeling that him and De Niro are gonna like knock this shit out of the park, man. So I'm super excited about that. I cannot wait for that movie.
That movie's gonna make.
Sticking on to the DC theme, there's a Birds of Prey teaser that they're not gonna put online. They've only it's only going to be in theaters. For it, they've only been showing it on the It Chapter 2. Like, if you're going to go watch It Chapter 2, they have this teaser up from Birds of Prey. Which is interesting to me that they only have it only it's only an on it's only a theater thing, which is kind of I don't get that nowadays. Because I know that back in the days, like in the 90s and shit, they would have, like, people would literally go watch a movie for a trailer. Like, I remember hearing stories about people going to watch a random movie in the 90s just to watch the Phantom Menace trailer. Remember?
Yeah.
Like, shit like that, you know what I mean? I don't get why they do that nowadays, because everything's on the internet. Like, I'll be honest, I've seen this trailer already.
Yeah, I was going to say, somebody's gone in there and filmed that shit.
I've seen it, because it's on the internet, so I don't understand wanting to keep it. Like, not, you know what I mean? Like,
I don't know either.
Anyway, the movie comes out February 7th, 2020. I'm looking forward to it. You know, it's got our boy Ewan McGregor in it. Obviously, you know, Margot Robbie's returning as, you know, Harley and stuff. So I hope it's good. I'm excited for it.
I want it to be I want everything I ever see to be good.
That's how I feel about it. So that's how whenever I watch things I don't like, I'm like,
oh, no, disappointed.
So disappointed. What else we got here? Here we go. So, what'd you think about that Tomb Raider movie with Alicia Vikander? Have you seen it?
I forgot it even existed.
Really?
Yeah.
Have you seen it, though?
No.
No?
Okay. It didn't look good. The CGI looked terrible, and it just looked bad.
I saw it, and I liked it. They're doing a sequel. Oh. It's coming out March 19th, 2021. Alicia Vikander is coming back as Lara Croft, and Ben Wheatley is going to be directing it. So this is cool, because I like the first one. I thought it was enjoyable for what it was, and it was based off like the newer, like the reboot of the Tomb Raider game series.
I remember the trailer. I remember CGI looking really bad. So.
Yeah. I haven't even played the newer Tomb Raider games, but I thought the movie was fun, man. I thought it was cool. So. I'll be looking forward to the next one.
I might check it out at some.
Yeah, you should give it a shot.
They're gonna do this, and then they're gonna do that Uncharted movie, and then they're gonna do a crossover.
Right?
I'd watch.
Yeah.
But yeah, that trailer.
I gotcha. I was just wondering, yeah, because they're doing a sequel.
But they are doing a sequel, so.
They are doing a sequel. Here we go. Hayley Atwell is joining the cast of the next Mission Impossible movie. And as you guys know, Hayley Atwell is our Peggy Carter in the MCU.
Yeah, perfectly.
Yeah, she'll be in the Mission Impossible. So, yeah, again, I think she's like perfect casting for this kind of movie. I love me some Hayley Atwell, so I'll definitely be checking out the next Mission Impossible. Because I watched the last one, Mission Impossible Fallout. Have you seen that one?
Yes.
I dug it, man.
Yes, I did.
It's got Henry Cavill in it.
Man, I like all the fucking Mission Impossible movies.
Fucking the reason why Henry Cavill looks fucked up in Justice League with his fucking lip was because he couldn't shave the mustache from that one movie.
He reloaded his fucking arms and beat the shit out of a dude.
He did, man. He fucking, yeah, he was whooping ass in that movie. He was good, dude. I
like
him.
That movie, yeah.
You know what I want to rewatch? Have you seen The Man from U.N.C.L.E. with him and Armie Hammer in it?
I've always been meaning to watch it and never have.
That I love that movie, man. It's good, dude. It's just like a spy movie. It's fucking cool, man. He's in it. Armie Hammer's in it. Alicia Vikander's in it. It's cool, man. I really enjoy that movie. I want to rewatch that. It's so fucking cool. But anyway, Hayley Atwell joining the cast of the next Mission Impossible. That's fucking cool. In some more, sticking with, you know, the MCU, since we talked about Hayley Atwell and her being in it. This is some pretty sad news. The Sony Pictures chief on the Spider-Man split, he says that for the moment, the door is closed on Spider-Man returning to the MCU.
Well, we need to bust that door open, buddy. What are you talking about?
I know, but this is what the Sony guy is saying. He says the door is closed for the moment.
Well, fuck that guy, you know what?
Unfortunately.
What I got to say to you.
This sucks, man. This really fucking blows, dude.
It really blows.
the way that Far From Home ended, I was more excited about this next Spider-Man 3 than I was for like any other Spider-Man movie until the last Spider-Man 3. Because I really love Spider-Man 2 or the Tobey Maguire Sam Raimi trilogy. Yeah. Like that's, to me, that's still my Spider-Man. Like I love that shit so much.
Oh god, Spider-Man 2.
I haven't been excited for a Spider-Man movie this much after watching Far From Home since then. So it's just super fucking disappointing that now we're not gonna.
Daniel's over here doing lines from The Godfather, like, "Look at how they massacred my boy."
Yeah, look at how they massacred my boy. I fucking hate it, man. I hate this so much.
Yeah, I know it sucks. It sucks.
It really, sucks. Really blows. So I'm very disappointed about that. Hopefully,
the fans lose. The fans lose, man.
We are the true losers in all of this. That's for sure.
That's what sucks.
We are the true losers in all of this. Well, I mean, it sucks, but we'll see, man. Hopefully, eventually, they can figure stuff out again.
For a long time, we never thought Spider-Man was going to be.
Would be in the MCU. So... Yeah, it's true. I mean, something is better than nothing. But they can't do that, man. The way that they ended it.
They gave it to us and it took it away. It took it away in a way that just sucks.
Like, that's some big old bullshit. Yeah. Okay? We gotta bring it back, man. Because we truly are the biggest losers in all of this. Yeah. Anyway, from that sad news, maybe this will cheer you up. Bad Boys for Life has a trailer.
I meant to watch this and forgot.
It's fucking silly, man. It's
I like those movies. I like those Bad Boy movies. They're fun.
Yeah, so put the trailer in the chat. Go. Maybe Josh will put it up.
Yeah, I got it up there.
There you go. There's, you know, Martin Lawrence and Will Smith are back for Bad Boys for Life, Bad Boys 3. This opening was the funniest thing to me in the entire trailer. You're opening the door up.
Oh.
And then fucking Martin Lawrence just smashes that shit on the thing. He's like, hey. And also, dude, Martin Lawrence looks bigger, man. What happened, dude?
He got old, traps.
I know, but look at Will Smith, man. Will Smith looks like... Will Smith never ages, man. And then this Martin Lawrence over here is like, man.
Genetics.
But yeah, I haven't seen these movies in so long, dude. I haven't seen them in so long.
You know what movie I like? Martin Lawrence movie I like? There's a couple. What? I like Blue Streak, where he's a jewel thief that pretends to be a cop. I like that movie. Where's that sequel? That's a good movie.
So yeah, it looks very. They bring him back the captain from the other movie, right?
Yeah.
Police guy. Yeah,
I can't, he's coming back from the other movies.
I don't remember his name either, but he's coming back from, I think, the second movie or something. And yeah, I mean, it looks like stuff you would expect from a Bad Boys movie.
Yeah. Yeah.
So yeah, there you go. That's I mean, it looks good though. Like, you know, they're driving through a mall and shit, and then Martin Lawrence is like, We're black cops. Don't worry, we'll pull ourselves over later. Yeah, Will Smith is continuing to whoop ass.
Yeah, it looks fun.
Yeah.
I'm sure it'll make a bunch of money just because people like those Bad Boy movies. So.
We'll see, man. It's been forever since the last one, so we'll have to see, man. We'll have to wait and see.
And Bad Boys was doing Fast and Furious before Fast and Furious. Yeah, that's true.
I believe that's all I got, though, movie wise. So stuff.
I got a trailer for Midway. Those of you that like a good war flick.
I like me some war flicks.
I assume it's a retelling of the Midway battle from World War II. It's directed by Roland Emmerich, and it's got nice. Luke Evans in it, Patrick Wilson, Mandy Moore, Dennis Quaid, Woody Harrelson, Aaron Eckhart.
It's a heck of a cast, man.
Yeah, and we'll see if it's any good. It looks like a fun action movie. I watched the old Midway. Here's the trailer. I throw it up. I should have threw it in the fucking video chat, but I didn't. I'm dumb. I'll do that when we're done watching it. But yeah, it looks pretty good. We'll flip through it here a little bit. But yeah,
Yeah,
maybe.
that's a heck of a cast, dude. I didn't realize this definitely looks like something I'm gonna checking out for sure.
I will definitely probably see it. My dad loves these two
I love me some
movies.
war flicks, man. I love me some war
Yeah,
flicks.
yeah. This looks very the CG. But yeah. The big thing is how do you make this movie? Because a lot of Midway and what made Midway such a big battle is just like all the planning that goes into setting it up. Like the battle. It's not the battle. The actual battle was very short compared to battles, but it'll be interesting nonetheless. I hope we have some good ass dogfights. I love a good dogfight.
Right, it's a lot of planes.
Yeah. It looks pretty good.
Heck yeah. Yeah, it does.
It looks fun. Watch a war movie. That looks fun. It
It
looks
looks
good. Not
fun.
fun. It just looks good. What I mean.
Looks like a blast. No, it looks good. Yeah. Veterans Day weekend. Okay. That makes sense.
But I like a good war movie.
Yeah, me too. Me too, man. Same here.
And we don't get them a lot anymore. We used to get them like all the time, and they're like all
The
old.
courage of a few. Yeah, they used to. Sure, you remember Pearl Harbor though? Ugh.
Oh God, terrible.
Big oof. Big oof on that one.
but we also got things like Saving Private Ryan and fucking Band of Brothers and
Saving Private
Pacific.
Ryan, Band of Brothers. I love. Yeah, you should do a fucking war movie podcast, dude.
Yeah, oh yeah, we
I
could.
love to do one on that,
A
man.
lot of
Saving Private Ryan, Full Metal Jacket,
Oh dude, I haven't seen
fucking
Full Metal
Black Hawk
Jacket in a long
Down,
time.
dude.
Black Hawk
Oh my
Down.
God, there's
A lot of mine
so
would
many good
also
ones,
probably
man.
be old things like Kelly's Heroes and like those kind of movies.
Yeah, man. Yeah, we should definitely do a podcast on like war movies. That'd
We
be
could do
fucking
that. We
dope.
could do that.
Hell yeah, man. You can dive into some of the history on some of this
Some of
shit
that
too, you
old
know.
my dad would fucking my dad would watch that episode. But
That'd be dope,
yeah.
man. Yeah. This movie looks good though. Midway.
That's Midway for you. I'll
Midway. Yeah,
post.
I'm glad you showed that because that looks fucking cool, man.
Yeah, that's because I noticed the trailer the other day and I was like,
Looks
wait,
good.
they already have a Midway movie that's really old. It's got Charlton Heston in it. Pretty good.
Oh shit, that's really old.
But yeah, I guess they're making a new.
Yeah, I somehow missed this trailer, but that looks fantastic.
All right, what else you got? Is that it? That's all we
That's all
got.
I got.
That's all I got.
You got anything else?
Yeah, I'm good.
All right then. I guess we can go ahead and move into our main topic.
Yeah, we don't need to take a break, I don't think, unless you need to, because I don't.
No.
Godzilla.
We need that sound effect of Godzilla roaring.
Jake,
I
join us in the call, quick, and then get a text message.
need the Baba to make her Godzilla noise. How she does it. Remember how
Oh
she's
my
doing it?
God.
Yeah. The Godzilla roar. Yeah, we need that.
What do you want
Okay,
to start with?
so how do you want to get into this? We can you want to just start off the new movie, or like you want to talk about the MonsterVerse in general, or how do you?
We can talk about MonsterVerse if you
All
want.
right, we'll talk about the MonsterVerse real quick. So,
You started that off because I
all
didn't
right,
watch any of the other movies you did.
so we're talking about this current. For those of you who don't know, we're talking about the current MonsterVerse that's happening right now, meaning Godzilla 2014, Kong Skull Island from 2017, I believe 2017, and then the new Godzilla movie, King of the Monsters, which released earlier this year in May, I believe. Or April, May, April and May, one of those. So that's what we're currently talking about. Since I knew that we were gonna watch this new movie f as the focus of our current for this episode of the podcast, I went ahead and rewatched the other two movies before I watched this new one. And it's cool, like when you're watching these movies, you see like the tie-ins and the mentions and references and stuff. Yeah, it's really cool. Like it's like they really have like, you know, they plant some stuff for you in there, like that you know,
Yeah,
that talks about and or yeah, references some of the other
there's a
movies,
ton of
which is
references
really neat.
in the new Godzilla movie,
In
though.
the new one, there's yeah, we'll talk about that, but
Yeah,
there's a lot. I was like, Jesus, man, there's so many in here.
but I don't, the
But
other ones I
yeah.
haven't seen in so long, I don't really remember all that much.
Oh yeah. Gotcha. Okay. So you want to just jump into the new movie then, or what's
Oh, we
up?
can don't talk about the old ones. You watched them.
The old
Talk, you
ones?
talk
Okay,
about them.
yeah, all
But
right.
you'll be the
So
one doing most of the talking while I kind of comment on it.
I rewatched. Yeah, so the first one I rewatched was Godzilla 2014. It had Bryan Cranston in it and Aaron Taylor Johnson, and of course Ken Watanabe and all those good folk. Yeah, so it's it's th this movie I remember watching in the theater, the 2014 one.
I didn't watch it till it
And
came out, I don't think. I didn't sit in
yeah,
the theater.
I didn't watch the new one in the theater, but I watched this 2014 one in the theater. And at the time, I the stuff that we saw from Godzilla was great. Like I like rewatching this movie, I think I liked it. I think I liked it a little bit more this time around. Like I still liked it when I first saw it, but I was like, yeah, man, this is actually a cool movie, man. Like I really like I had fun with it. This watch rewatching it again.
Yeah.
I'm still disappointed with like certain things. Like spoiler alert, spoiler alert, spoiler alert. Fucking Bryan Cranston goes out in the movie like kind of early on. So I'm like, man, like that kind of sucks.
I
But
think my biggest issue with the first movie, from what I remember of it, is like they just tease Godzilla so much.
So this is my issue here, okay?
Yeah.
I think this is my issue also with this new movie, is that they focus too much on the human character. And here's my thing, man. When I watch these movies, I don't give a fuck about the human characters. I just want to watch these kaiju titans, whatever you want to call them, fucking fight each other, man. Listen to Ken Watanabe in the first movie, man. Let them fight, bro. I want to see them fight, man. I want to see them fight. That's why I'm watching this movie. I don't want to, when I watch these movies, I don't want to watch an Oscar award-winning movie, man. Like it's, you know what I mean? Like I want to watch
Yeah.
some monsters fucking fight, man.
Yeah.
And like they focus too much on the human stuff, and I'm just like, I don't care, man. I don't care.
When we talk about the new movie, I got some thoughts on this.
But anyway, that's just like my that's my feelings on that personally. We'll get into a little bit more, but that's I'm just like, dude, I just want to watch these monsters fight, man. It's not all bad. Don't get me wrong. It's not all bad. Like I some of the characters are like they're fine. Like I think Aaron Taylor Johnson's character in the first movie is cool. Like his whole family unit, like that's fine and stuff.
Yeah.
But yeah, like in the first movie they like they show like Godzilla about to fight the the creature. And then they like cut off. I'm
Yeah.
like, oh, come on, man.
They tease it so bad.
They tease it so much. But you know what? At the end, when we finally get to see the fight, it's fucking cool. It's like the best part of that movie when you, yeah, it's the best. But I mean, I guess it is kind of cool seeing like Aaron Taylor Johnson with like his, following the whole military thing. Like they're taking the bomb to the on the train and stuff, and they're guiding it to the thing, whatever. They drop off from the plane into the city and whatnot, and like I guess that kind of stuff is all right, but like I don't know. I guess my whole point is that yeah, I just wish they would focus more on like the monsters actually fighting each other, as opposed to like being like, oh, people are gonna get bored of that, so let's just have human characters in here
I never get bored of
that
monsters
like
fighting, man.
I know like that's the reason why I want to watch those movies, man, because I want to see Godzilla fuck some ass up, man. I want to see him fuck
It's why
some
I
ass
like
up, dude.
Pacific Rim. It's like I like Rampage. That movie was okay. I like the video game Rampage.
I just want to see these guys. I want to see these monsters fight, man.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But then they're like, oh, here's, a bunch of human stuff that I like, eh. Which I know that the older like Godzilla movies also have human stuff, but like, whatever.
I want more monster as well as I'm fine with the little human stuff. I want more monster. Give me
It's
more
like
monster.
of course any movie, every movie is gonna have human stuff. Like you're not gonna, take that element out because people are too afraid to like make a movie based entirely on like non-humans or whatever. But like just like don't focus on it so much, man. Like anyway, this is how I feel about it. Like I wish they
I
would.
wasn't as big a fan of that first movie, to be honest.
I liked it when I first saw it, and then That was those were some of my issues with it. Like the human, they focused too much on the human stuff. You know, Bryan Cranston was like, they brought up his name a lot, like in the marketing, and then like, oh, he dies like halfway through, like the beginning of the movie or whatever. And then
they made him seem like such a massive part.
Yeah, he was gonna be like a huge part of it, and then he just ends up dying. And I mean, he was good though. Like Bryan Cranston is always good, but like, yeah, he just wasn't in it for too long. And like, yeah, I don't know, man. It's just. Again, too much of the human stuff, but when we do get to see Godzilla fight the Mutos, it's fucking cool, man. Like I really dig that stuff, man. Like that's what I want to see these movies for. Bam, bam. Is to see Godzilla fuck some shit up. And he fucks some shit up in the end of that movie, man. I love when at the end of the movie he like is about to kill the last one and he just like opens up the mouth of the Muto and like, you know, atomic breasts it like in its mouth. And God. That's so cool, dude. I'm like, it's so fucking cool.
It's metal. And there's something similar
to that. Yeah, I really dig that shit, man. It's so cool. It's awesome. That's the stuff that I want to see in these movies.
Dang, man.
Yeah, but anyway, that's the stuff that I enjoy.
You watch Kong too? You want to talk about?
I watch Kong, which by the way, I really like that Kong movie.
I like that Kong movie too.
That Kong Skull Island is fucking awesome, dude. If you guys haven't seen Kong Skull Island. It's a part of the MonsterVerse, so if you've seen Godzilla 2014 and the new Godzilla, it's called King of the Monsters, you should watch Kong Skull Island, because there's, you know...
It's pretty good.
Which, by the way, we haven't mentioned this, but next year, 2020, Kong versus Godzilla is coming out.
Yep. Actually, relatively soon.
Yeah, like 2020, like next year, like months from now, like it's coming. Kong Skull Island is awesome. I really dig this movie, man.
First of all,
yeah, let's talk about the cast. They got Tom Hiddleston, Samuel L. Jackson, Brie Larson, John Goodman, John C. Reilly, Corey Hawkins, Jason Mitchell, Toby Kebbell. It's a hell of a cast, man.
Yep.
And like I really like this movie, man. I think this movie is fucking cool, dude.
I like it too. It's really good.
It takes place in like the you know. Like post-Vietnam era, you know, sometime in the 70s, I believe.
1973.
Yeah, it's a really, really cool movie, man.
Like, of course, it opens up in like 1944 because it opens up.
Yeah, it does. The beginning of the movie, yeah, it opens up with, you know, World War II and like, you know, there's a two pilots that crashed on Skull Island. And
you haven't seen it, Paula? Get out of here.
Oh, shit. Well, let me not get into too many spoilers.
Go watch it. Good.
It's really cool, Paul. You should check it out. Yeah, there's a fucking John C. Reilly reference from Dr. Steve Brule on the back of his jacket. I was like, yes, I love it. So good.
I like John C. Reilly.
He's cool, man. Yeah, he's actually really good in this movie. I like him.
Yeah, not a lot of movies.
You know what's funny though? Underrated. I've been shitting on like how the Godzilla movies don't like. I don't really like the human characters don't really do it for me. I really like the human characters in this movie, man.
Yeah.
I do. I think they're fucked. Again, this movie works for me, man. I think this movie is like great. I really, really enjoy this movie.
You can stay, Paul. And you we'll get, try not to spoil it.
And you get to see God, like King Kong actually like fight stuff, and you get to see him like at the beginning of the movie, and you know, they don't do what Godzilla did and like wait till like, you know, way later to show him for the first time and stuff. I really enjoy this movie, man. It's really cool.
I think it's just because the cast seems smaller, because it's not like a bunch of red shirts in the background, right? like there's some red shirts in there, but
yeah.
But like in the first Godzilla, there's just like columns of troops and just
yeah, because there's a lot of people because in the first Godzilla movie, I forgot to mention also they travel a lot from city to city.
Mm-hmm.
They're like in Honolulu and San Francisco and, you know, Tokyo. And they go like all over the place, you know, all over the world.
I think that's probably the issue. They pop around.
And Skull Island, they're just like, it's a group of people. And you're stuck on Skull Island the majority of the movie, you know. So, I don't know. I just, yeah, I really, 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 like rewatching it again, I was like, this is a fun movie, man.
Yeah.
So I really enjoyed it. And of course they have like references at the end of the movie, spoiler alert, they show Godzilla and you know, like they look at stuff. You know how they have like the stuff on the wall where they have like, I think in the first, I think, was it in the first? I just rewatched them, but I don't remember already. In the first Godzilla movie, did they have something referenced to Kong or no?
I don't remember. I know they do in the new
Oh.
one.
Yeah, in the new one they do, but I
I
don't
don't
think,
know. I don't think.
not in the first one,
I
right? I think
don't
it was
think
too early
so.
for them to be like, we're gonna start a universe, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, it might have been too early. But anyway, at the end of Kong Skull Island, they have like the thing on the wall where they have Godzilla fighting Ghidorah. So they're like, oh boy, King of the Monsters, that's the next movie, you know? So yeah, at the end of the movie they have Tom Hiddleston and Brie Larson and a couple other people looking at that thing.
Yeah.
Oh, that's our next movie there.
'Cause they get recruited by Monarch.
Yeah.
I
Yeah,
like
yeah,
that.
yeah,
I
yeah,
like that
yeah.
Kong movie.
Yeah, I like it, man. Again, after rewatching it again, I really enjoy that movie. I think it's fun as hell. I love the like some of the shots, and the soundtrack is fantastic for this movie. I really love the soundtrack to Kong Skull Island, the imagery and the scenery and the shots that they have in this, like just the cinematography in general is just like
Yeah.
really, really cool. It's great. I can't say enough like positive things about it. I enjoy it, man. I really like Kong Skull Island. So if you haven't seen it, I would recommend it. Came out 2 years ago. It's a part of the MonsterVerse universe that we're currently in right now with Kong and Godzilla and whatnot. So definitely check that out.
All right.
And this will guide us into Godzilla King of the
All
Monsters.
right, I want to start us off on this.
So yeah, you go ahead and start off. I've
And
talked enough for now.
because I want to talk about, I'm just going to talk about the couple things I didn't like. And
Okay.
that is, I hate all the human characters. They're fucking stupid, except for like three of them.
Okay.
There are three characters that are not fucking stupid.
Who?
Millie
Who?
Bobby
Who? Who?
Brown's character is not fucking
Uh-huh.
stupid. She's great.
She's great. Yeah.
Ken
I thought she
Watanabe's
was great.
character is
Ken
great.
Ken's always he's fucking awesome. But yeah.
Zhang Ziya, the doctor twins.
Oh, the twin lady. Yeah.
She's not fucking stupid. The rest, everybody else is fucking stupid, except Charles Dance, but that's because Charles Dance is great. but all the rest of them are just dumb. They're all stupid. That's my issue. They make them all stupid. Like the doctor man is stupid. The lady, why she's the villain, quote unquote. I feel like her entire plan is stupid. The monster stuff's great though. I have issues with the humans in this movie. Oh, I lost Daniel. Shit. Uh-oh. I lost Daniel, guys. What happened? I lost my other guy. Aren't people stupid? This is true. People are stupid, but oh my God, this is like next level stupid. Like you, these are supposed to be doctors. These are supposed to be smart people. And yep. I don't know what happened to Daniel. All right. Well, we'll try to get him back. I'll try to keep talking. I don't know. All the monster stuff's good though. I really enjoy I really enjoy all the they open up sh kind of talk they open up kind of showing off all about the other monsters. Give me one second while I try to figure out what this. Whoop. We'll keep talking. It's not a big deal. I'm just kind of worried what happened to Daniel. Give me one second, guys. We're gonna restart the call real quick. See if that fix it. I got you back.
What the hell happened, man?
I have no idea what happened.
I was like, what the fuck is going on?
All right, we're back. I was like criticizing, and then you left. I was like, oh shit, Daniel's mad at me because I said I
Hello.
hate the humans. No, I'm kidding.
Yes, I was drinking some orange juice. Oh, yeah. So this is what happened with me, right? It starts with Godzilla 2014, Paula. It's Godzilla 2014, Kong Skull Island, and then the new Godzilla movie that came out this year, King of the Monsters. So, anyways, I was saying, you started to talk about stuff, and then like my, I audio went out for me. I was like, wait a minute. I was like, what? I couldn't hear you on Discord, but I was looking at stream and you were like talking and stuff, right? And then I was like, what? So then I noticed that my thing froze. So I was like, well, let me just end it and then like redo it again. And it still didn't work. So I was like, well, fuck it. Let's just try to restart this. But yeah.
Why do I dislike Millie Bobby Brown's mom? Her plan may have worked, but she committed genocide. She murdered hundreds of thousands, if not millions, of people. I think she's dumb. I think she's evil.
What did you talk about while I was like?
I said I hate every character except Millie Bobby Brown, Charles.
I heard that. Okay, yeah. That's the last thing I heard was Charles Dance. And then after that, I don't know what happened.
Ken Watanabe and then the twins.
I heard that. Because Charles Dance was the last name that you mentioned. So I was like, okay. All right. I think, again, this movie also, like, I just, the human characters, man. I'm just like, dude, I wish we would focus more on the
Their plan without Ghidorah going rogue would have killed almost no one. Anyone? Yeah, that's the problem, though. They're giant monsters. How do you try to expect to control giant monsters? I'm sorry. I just she's dumb. I think she's dumb. I disagree. I think she's stupid.
Also, fucking Ice Cube's son is in this.
Yeah.
I was like, hey, it's him. But yeah, here. So the first thing that I noticed at the beginning of the movie was I noticed that. So they start off the movie with, you know, kind of the aftermath of the first Godzilla movie, right? They have like Kyle Chandler's character and the mother and the young daughter, which, by the way, the young daughter is played by fucking Lexi Rabe, who's Morgan Stark in Endgame. Did you notice that?
I didn't actually until you just said that.
Yeah, she was Morgan Stark, dude. The young Millie Bobby Brown character. She was the young version of her. So I was like, that's pretty cool. Yeah, I mean, that was pretty cool how they like referenced the first movie. Like, I always personally like when they like mention previous movies in the newer movies, or like, oh, you know, here are these characters in this movie that you didn't see in the movie before that were here. You know what I mean? Like, I always dig that kind of stuff. So I thought that was pretty cool, the way they started off the movie like that. But I'm in agreement with you with the human characters. I just, like, I don't know why, man. Both of these Godzilla movies, I'm just like, I just want to see the monsters fight.
Which is
man.
Fine. It's fine. I also feel like this movie suffers from having too many faces. They show a lot of different people. I feel like. And then they kill off a few, like, immediately, which is fine. But it's, like, I think it suffers from just showing too many faces. I think if you had a smaller cast and showing off the monsters more, it probably would have
been. That's probably why I enjoyed Kong Skull Island more.
Which is not to say I don't like the movie. I actually like the movie. The movie's good. I just have issues with the humans. They're stupid.
I like it, too. But, yeah, again, my problem is all the human stuff.
Yeah. And I pretty much knew Millie Bobby Brown's mom was gonna fucking spoilers.
I didn't know.
Spoilers. I knew she was gonna die because I'll tell you straight up, you do not kill that many people, even with good intentions, and get to live at the end of the movie. There's no way. I was like, they would have her arrested for genocide at the end. So I'm like, yeah, she's gonna die before this is over with. So.
Right.
And she did. There's no way she's going to... I just didn't like her. I hated every human character besides Millie Bobby Brown and Charles Dance.
Besides Millie Bobby Brown and Charles Dance.
Ken Watanabe. And
yeah, Ken Watanabe is always, like, the best.
And you're legally not allowed to hate Charles Dance, especially when he says things like, long live the king. Like, fucking
long live the king.
He's not even in the movie a whole lot, really, I don't think.
He isn't.
But he's great in it.
Which we'll talk about something that he does later in the movie, but it was fun. Speaking of which, it was funny seeing Tywin Lannister kidnap Eleven.
Yeah.
You know? Fucking Charles Dance kidnaps Millie Bobby Brown. I'm like, hey, let's go. And it's funny because she gives him the middle finger and stuff. but yeah.
But they open up this movie. They show off like a bunch of references.
Yeah. So. Oh, dude. Yeah, there's so many. But let's talk about the actual like the kaijus real quick. Like, first of all, this is the order that they get introduced in.
They
We
made
have
some up, I
Mothra.
think.
Mothra first. Oh yeah, they did make some up. Mothra goes first. Then we get Ghidorah, then we get Rodan. Which introduction did you like the most of these? Of
Ooh.
the three, like of the three main ones apart from Godzilla? Because I can tell you which one I like the most,
I
probably.
don't know if I can pick a favorite, but I like them
Like
all.
intro, like I'm talking about like intro, like when they were first introduced into the
No,
movie.
I like all their intros though. I like
Like
Mothra's
for me,
intro. I like
fucking
Rodan's a lot.
Rodan's was fucking crazy, dude,
Yeah,
with
the
the
fucking
volcano and shit. And he just like flew over that town and fucking killed everyone. I was like, dude, this is fucking nuts, man. That was probably my favorite one because I was like, this is bonkers,
I
man.
thought they were all good. I think all their introductions were really good. I like Ghidorah's.
The Ghidorah one was fucking cool too, man.
And
With the yeah, that one
when
was
they come
cool.
out and he like bites the other head at like one of his other heads because it's doing something stupid. That made me laugh. But yeah.
They were all pretty good, yeah. But yeah, I think for me, Rodan was probably the like
Oh,
wow almost.
Rodan's was pretty cool. They were all pretty cool.
Yeah, but again,
That's the thing the
Ghidorah's
movie
was
does
awesome
right.
too.
It does the fucking monsters right. Right.
Yeah, it does.
Absolutely
Which
does.
I wish I wish we got more of that. Yeah. Yeah, like I wish we would have got more of that because all that stuff is like again what I want to see these movies for, and I love that shit, man. It's fucking cool. But yeah, I thought they were all really, really like all the monster stuff was pretty cool. Like the introductions and these motherfuckers are huge, man. Like when you see them flying too, like the wings are colossal, dude. I'm like, good lord, man.
The other thing this movie
Things are.
does good, it does sound really well. It does music very well. Like the sound of the monsters is really good. The sound of all their abilities is
You know
really
what I need
good.
to do? I haven't done this, but I need to listen to the soundtrack.
Yeah, I should do that
Cause
too.
I know people like really like enjoy this soundtrack for the new movie, which I believe, if I'm not mistaken, who does the soundtrack to this? I think it's Bear McCreary, right?
I have no idea.
Is it Bear McCreary who does the soundtrack to this? Because I know he didn't do it for the first one. The first one was like fuck, who did the soundtrack to the first movie? I think it was Alexandre Desplat. I think he did the first movie. But Bear McCreary, I think, did the second movie. And I haven't listened to it yet, but I gotta like go into it and like listen to everything because yeah, I'm always a sucker for like good soundtracks and stuff. Like I have a playlist on Spotify dedicated to soundtracks and scores and stuff. So I definitely gotta get into that and listen to it. Bear McCreary, okay, yeah, Bear McCreary did do it. Okay. Yeah, so I gotta go back and listen to the soundtrack because I'm sure there's some really good shit in there that I like maybe might have missed or whatever while watching the movie. Because when you watch a movie for the first time, there's a lot that you can miss, you know.
Yeah, especially
Because
fucking
you're watching it for the first time.
giant fucking monsters fighting
Yeah, when you're
too.
watching amazingness like Ghidorah in the fucking like darkness and there's like lightning and shit, that's cool. Anyway.
I like the Orca device. I think that's clever.
Oh, the thing that can like control them or whatever.
Yeah, one of the main plot points of the movie is that device, the little
Yeah, which like apparently only the Russells know how to use,
yeah, apparently.
which is why they were important.
But yeah, I dig it. You need some way to kind of,
Yeah.
and I thought it was fun.
Yeah,
I
just
think
yeah, it's
I feel
just
like some people would be bothered by that, but I thought it was cool. I thought it was an interesting way to show it.
Yeah, I didn't mind it that much either. It was just kind of weird, but what'd you think of the oxygen destroyer bomb?
Thought it was fine.
Yeah. Cool. Yeah, it was
It's a
they
little
used the oxygen.
weird, but it's fine.
I was like, well, that's a weapon.
That's a thing.
Although I think if I'm not mistaken, they've done something similar to this in the previous Godzilla movies.
I think so.
I'm not too familiar with like all of the Godzilla lore and history because like I haven't seen all of them. I've seen some here and there, but I haven't seen all of them. But I think they've done something like the oxygen destroyer bomb like in previous stuff. So I think that's something that could call back to
It's
something.
fine. It's fine. It's just like it just came out of nowhere. I think it's kind of like
Yeah.
it's like we've been developing this weapon. It's an oxygen destroyer. Which is kind of weird. But yeah. But it was fine. They did something. It was fine. And then, we're gonna spoil the shit out of this movie, so if you haven't seen it yet, turn this off now. If you
The
have, I've
Oxygen
already spoiled some
Destroyer.
things.
Yeah, we've been spoiling stuff here. And the Oxygen Destroyer was used in the very first movie to kill Godzilla and used throughout the Godzilla. Okay, so yeah, it's something that's like a common thing in the
Common thing.
Godzilla movies.
Yeah.
Okay.
I just wish they explained it a little bit more. That's all. I just felt very left field.
Okay.
Because I just wasn't expecting it. That was all. Which is
So
probably a good thing, I guess, since I
let's
used
talk
it
about
more.
Ken Watanabe for a little bit,
Yeah.
because
Spoilers.
I his character kind of, I don't know how I feel about his character, because I like him, like Ken Watanabe's cool, but I feel like in the first movie his character was more of like a, I don't know, like more of a guy that I don't know if like he had more to do. I don't know if that's right, but like I feel like I liked his character more in the first movie than this one. I don't know why. Like in this movie, he's kind of like just like taking orders, and like he like there's a weird thing that he there's a weird joke where he's like, I read it in a fortune cookie, and I'm like, what?
Yeah, that was really
That was
weird.
super weird. But I'm like, huh?
Some of the humor in this movie doesn't land.
I'm just like, what now? But I mean, I don't know. Yeah, he's still one of like my of all the human characters, he's still like my favorite. But like,
It was a long fortune cookie.
dude, spoiler alert. He fucking dies, man. I'm like,
Yeah.
no, Ken Watanabe, no, no.
I thought his death was good, but I didn't want him to die because I love Ken Watanabe.
I know, me too. Yeah, I know. Same here. So, spoiler, he dies when he tries to, like, you know, help Godzilla out because Godzilla's, like, injured in
They have to
the
feed
bottom
him
of
a
the ocean.
feed him
Yeah.
a nuke of all
You gotta give him a
things.
nuke because he needs to get, you know, he needs that energy.
It's the fresh maker.
After the oxygen bomb, after the oxygen destroyer bomb fucks him up, so he needs, what does he need? Another bomb to fucking help him out,
Yeah,
right?
you know what's good about bad bombs? You got good bombs, you know.
Yeah.
But yeah, like Godzilla is like fighting Ghidorah, and then they shoot that oxygen bomb, and it
Yeah.
fucks up Godzilla, but it doesn't bother Ghidorah because it turns out Ghidorah's a fucking alien.
Yup, he's not from our world. But yeah, speaking of Ken or Ken Watanabe's character, fucking the other doctor lady who was with him died in the movie as well earlier.
Yeah, she gets
She
eaten.
just gets like eaten. I'm like, oh
Like
no.
with like almost no, like if you blinked, you'd have missed it.
Yeah,
And then
like
they show
just
her
like
like
that.
dead on the screen later.
Like rip.
And
Well,
that's what I'm talking about. There were too many faces, right? They showed her face, made out like she was kind of important, and she gets eaten, which is fine.
yeah.
But I just think you didn't need that when you have a cast of so many other characters already.
Yeah.
Which is fine. I get it.
Yeah, I would have liked for her and Ken to like, you know, stay alive until like Kong, at least, just so we can see like what Godzilla versus Kong would have been like with them in it, but whatever. I know they had the story they wanted to tell.
Yeah. And Mothra shows up. She Godzilla's
So
bae.
yeah, speaking of Mothra though, real quick. I'm curious. So throughout the movie, we're seeing like Godzilla chase Ghidorah, right? There's like a whole section where they're like chasing Godzilla, or Godzilla's chasing Ghidorah, and they're like chasing Godzilla on their like big old giant airship or whatever. Which, by the way, that airship's pretty cool. But where the hell were Rodan and Mothra at for some time? I feel like they were like on. We were like chasing. We were following Godzilla, following Ghidorah. But where was Mothra and Rodan? Did I like miss out on something?
I don't know.
Where were they at for a hot minute? I feel like they were out of the action for a
I
while,
feel like
and they
there's
didn't.
some random disappearances, but I think it they didn't really have a choice.
I feel like they were out of it for a while, and they didn't show up until the end again. Maybe I missed something, but I feel like they were out of it for a while, both Mothra and
At
Rodan.
one point when Mothra leads to Godzilla after the fight they have with Ghidorah and the oxygen bomb goes off, she disappears for a
Yeah.
bit. Did you watch the post-credit stuff?
I did.
So you saw the egg. So I just
Yeah.
assumed she went and laid the egg.
Yeah.
And
Okay.
that one disappearance, which makes sense to me. I don't
I
remember.
guess that would make sense. I could see that happening.
But yeah.
I was just wondering, like, where the hell is Mothra and Rodan?
But there are just a couple little random. I don't know where they're at. But I get like you don't need to show us all the time because there's
No,
like
I know.
Pluto and stuff.
I was just curious, you know, like where the hell they are when, like, you know, there's all this. Because I mean, because there's also a bunch of other kaiju around the world that we get to see, right? like they're attacking Paris or they're attacking this city or whatever. So that was pretty cool. I kind of wish we'd seen more of that
Dude,
stuff.
the big mammoth one,
The woolly mammoth thing, that
that's
was fucking cool.
straight up out of Frozen Decimation. Just
Which,
saying.
by the way, I think that thing was created for this movie.
Yeah, I think it's called the Behemoth or something. It looked cool.
Yeah, there was a lot of those titans or kaijus that were created for this movie, I believe.
I read some of the trivia last night, and they're like, "Yeah, we made some because like you have to pay for the names for like you got to pay the
Yeah, like Toho
the
or
studio,
whatever.
yeah, Toho. You got to pay them every one of those names got a number attached to it, which makes sense. They're all big. Like any of those monsters could lead their own movie.
That's cool,
So
though. I mean, the big woolly mammoth thing is pretty cool. They
I
had
think it's cool.
another.
That I was fine with them making that stuff.
They had another Muto in this too, I believe. So God, so which Godzilla, which means that he didn't kill all of them in the first movie.
Yeah, I thought the whole point of the first this is why I got confused on it. Maybe it's just me not knowing my remembering the first movie that well, but I thought like those two were like the last two, and then there's like one that shows up here.
Well, they were trying to like the female one was like trying to lay eggs and shit, remember? Like
Yeah.
she does at one point, and then like Aaron Taylor Johnson's character like destroys all of them, burns them all up and stuff. But yeah, I was like, there's another one in this movie, which I think is cool, but I'm like, well, huh.
It's like
How is there another
it
one?
wasn't like addressed at all. It was like
No, it was like, here's another
it's
one.
like I was like, that looks like the one from the first movie. I thought those were the last two. Am I wrong?
Yeah, I mean, they're cool looking, and you know, it's cool that there's a bunch more like
They
out there.
look like the fucking arachnids, fucking Starship Troopers.
Which, by the way, we gotta rewatch that movie. I want to rewatch Starship. There's a lot of movies I want to rewatch. That's the problem. Like, I want to watch new things, but it's like I want to rewatch old stuff too. Anyway, but yeah, so that was just, I was just curious about like where Mothra and Rodan were for a while.
They also had showed off the big fucking mountain one. They were like showing a mountain and then that fucking mountain erupts.
Oh, there's a lot of like different,
Yeah, they showed off
yeah,
like a bunch
kaiju
of
in this that I'm
it's
like,
like
oh, I want to
17
see
and
more of these
counting.
guys.
And I was like, wow, they're showing off a lot of these monsters and I kind of wasn't
They are.
expecting that.
They are. Which, by the way, we'll talk about that a little bit later because I'm curious how they're going to do that, what they're going to do with that in the next movie. But,
Yeah.
so here's also another question that I have. Is it only me, or I thought that when Ghidorah picked up Godzilla and he flew him up in the air and dropped him, I feel like maybe when Godzilla dropped, that him falling to the ground should have been more devastating to the ground. Because that's a big ass. Godzilla's fucking giant, okay? And that motherfucker dropped from high up in the air. That should have been more
I
devastating
thought
than it
it was gonna
actually
be like
was,
the
man.
equivalent of a nuke going off when he landed, 'cause he's huge. He's
Which,
even
by the way,
bigger by this point.
get fucked, Boston, because Boston got destroyed.
Yeah, fuck you, Patriots.
Yeah, I mean, anyway, like I thought that when he like picked them up in the air and dropped them, I thought that that was gonna be a lot more destructive than it actually was, man. I don't know. I felt like maybe it would have been, but I guess not. I don't know. I don't know. I don't know how that works really, but
I
that was a
mean,
big drop from a big boy. So that's all. Yeah, there's a lot of like Godzilla's dead, but wait, no, he isn't. Godzilla's dead. No way, he's coming back.
it happens a
You
little
know?
bit, but
Yeah, it happens a few
I love
times.
after he eats the nuke and the fucking music starts playing and shit and he comes up out of the fucking ocean.
Yeah, I
Oh
mean,
my
again, the
God.
music is something I have to go back to and revisit
The
because I feel like it's.
classic Godzilla theme, that moment was dope. Dope. I loved it. I loved it. That. Burr, 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 burr. You know that one? Oh my God. The
Yeah, I
classic.
gotta, I gotta listen to that soundtrack,
Oh, it
man.
was so. I love that part. That part's great. I
Who
see why
else you
Baba
got?
loves Mothra. I love Mothra too.
Mothra? Yeah, you're a Mothra fan.
I'm a Mothra
Well,
fan.
that's another thing you and Dababa can bond over. The Mothra love, yeah.
Mothra was great in this movie.
Which rip Mothra, but of course, there's like Josh mentioned earlier, there's an egg, so she'll be back.
Yeah. Mothra never really dies.
That's like another common theme in the Godzilla stuff, right? Is that Mothra keeps dying, but then she comes back again.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She's like life, death, and then rebirth and like all that kind of stuff. I am a big Mothra fan.
Yeah,
And
there's Dababa.
I like that scene where Godzilla's hasn't eaten the nuke yet. They're like searching for him, and then Mothra comes through with the wings and like blows all the clouds and shit away. And like that's really cool. I like that scene. That's really cool. Monsters Queen, yo.
Yeah, she's pretty cool. Again, the wings is like it was very pretty when you see like, you know, the way the first time you see the wings fly out and stuff, and they like reveal her for the first time or whatever. It's pretty cool.
Yeah, I like Mothra.
Which again, the wings for those fucking things are huge, man. Like they're you see them like flying in the air, they're massive. But anyway.
Which we talk about Ghidorah and Godzilla a lot, but fucking Mothra throws down with Rodan.
Yeah, that was cool.
Fucking has a fight with that motherfucker.
That was dope.
And it was a good
Again,
fight.
that's more of the stuff I want to see, man. Just watch these giant fucking creatures fight each other, man.
It's good.
Like, that's what I want to see, man. That's what I want to see from these movies.
I want to see more of that, yeah.
Less yeah.
I think I just like smaller cast more and then bigger monsters.
Yeah, that's probably why I enjoyed like Kong Skull Island more, because they're stuck in one area. You know the group of people you're with, and you see fucking Kong fucking shit up, so that's great. So here's another thing I'm curious about.
Okay.
There's a Titan party at the end, right? Yeah. There's like at the end of the movie, they all Godzilla defeats, you know,
Ghidorah,
and there's all these Titans coming up to him. And you see the woolly mammoth, you see the Muto, you see all the other ones.
The big spider. We didn't even talk about the big spider. The fucking big spider one.
The spider
it's got a
thing
name.
Is pretty crazy too, right? They all—I mean—they all have names, but I don't fucking.
I don't
know
how you say it. It's like it starts with an S.
With an S.
I think.
I feel like. Let me see.
I was like, oh my god, giant ass spider.
There was so many of them. I was trying to see like how many of them there were, really. Like, cause there's quite a Scylla. Okay, there you go. Yeah, Scylla. I believe that's it right there.
Yeah.
But
yeah, you were saying about all the monsters coming up.
Yeah, there's quite a few of them, right? Mm-hmm. Obviously, you have, you know, Godzilla. You have Ghidorah. You have Rodan. You have Mothra. Then you start getting into the other stuff. Like, you know, the Scylla, again, the spider thing.
It's Behemoth.
The Behemoth, which is the woolly mammoth thing, I believe.
The Muto.
Yeah. The Mutos, yeah. What's the... I'm trying to think of what some of the other ones are.
I'm bad at remembering names.
There's a few more that I'm trying to remember.
Yeah, they show off quite a few.
I'm probably gonna like Google a list or something. Let me see.
All the monsters.
Let me see. Yeah. All right, Godzilla, Mothra, Ghidorah, Rodan. The Scylla's the spider thing. Titan is Behemoth. No, that doesn't seem right.
Man, King. Methuselah, that's that big mountain one.
Okay. Oh, the mountain titan was the Methuselah or whatever.
Yeah, I don't know how you say it. But...
And there's apparently a bunch of names that we didn't see.
Yeah, like there's one that's called Tiamat, like the D&D. Like the
Yeah. There's like a bunch of them that we didn't see, but like they were just named off or whatever.
Baphomet.
Which, speaking of which, there's a lot of King Kong references in this movie.
There are, like, I wasn't expecting.
There is. I was like, yo, are we gonna see Kong in this movie? I mean, obviously, like, you know, they're gonna save it for the next one, which is Kong versus Godzilla. But like, there's so many, dude. There's a lot of. I think at one point you see him like in a like footage from before or whatever. Like, you know what I mean.
Apparently, he's mentioned in the novelization of the movie, mm-hmm. when Ghidorah is like calling all the Titans, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And apparently, in the novelization, Kong ignores him. He ignores the pleas from Ghidorah or whatever. Not the pleas, the fucking commands or whatever.
The call or whatever. Yeah. Yeah, because I was like, dude, there's all these Titans are like moving, like are all around the world. I'm like, where the fuck is Kong during all this?
Yeah, he ignores him. That's why.
I mean, he's probably on Skull Island, right? But like, he's, you know, like, dude, like, what is he doing? I'm just curious about what he's doing while all this is happening. You know what I mean?
He's probably fighting some more of the monsters on Skull Island.
Which, by the way. Yeah, there's a mass kaiju migration towards Skull Island at the end of the movie,
Yep.
remember? So my thinking on this is, you said that Kong rejected Ghidorah's call because he's like another alpha like type, you know.
Yeah, definitely. He's fucking king, yeah.
Yeah, he's another king. Yeah, he's King Kong. He's another king. And Godzilla's obviously a king, as we get to see at the end. There's creatures that go to him.
What is a king to a
So
god?
there's gonna be a bunch of other ones going to Skull Island. Dude, fucking King Kong is gonna have his boys and girls, and fucking Godzilla's gonna have his boys and girls, and they're gonna fight in the next movie, dude.
They're
I
gonna
wanna see that happen so bad, dude.
fucking throw down.
Just have their own posses like fight each other, dude. Yes, please.
Who do you want to win?
Ooh, that's a good question, man. I don't know.
Who you got
Because
money on?
here's the
5% chance.
thing. Here's the thing is, like, I think generally, typically, historically, King Kong is like smaller than Godzilla, right? But in this MonsterVerse, they did the smart thing by stating in Kong Skull Island, which I just saw, which is how I remember this, is that they said that Kong is still growing and he hasn't reached his like full, you know, height yet. So I wonder how big he's gonna be in the next movie.
They're gonna throw down now.
Because he's gonna have to be a lot bigger, because Godzilla's a big motherfucker, you know what I mean? And Kong was pretty big, but he still wasn't like, you know, he hadn't reached his full potential yet. So I'm curious about that. But that's what I really want to see, because there's a mass kaiju migration headed towards Skull Island, which means there are, while Godzilla has people or people kaiju going to him, Kong's gonna have some going to him too. Because he's also a big boy that, you know, like, you know, he's a leader. You know, Godzilla's a leader, Kong's a leader. They're both gonna have their own.
Fucking one's a god, one's a king, yo.
Yeah, they're gonna have their posses with them. So I'm gonna be very curious to see like what's gonna happen with that. They're gonna fight each other, and it's gonna be great. I can't wait.
Yeah, I'm curious to how they do that. I wonder if they're gonna do the cop out thing and have them join together at the end to fight some bigger threat. Like,
Dude,
I hate that shit.
I'm sorry to disappoint you, but I have a feeling that's what it's gonna be.
I think it's gonna be that too.
They're probably it's you know what this you know what this movie's probably gonna be? It's gonna be Batman v Superman.
It is.
They're gonna fight for a little bit and then be like, let's be friends. And then no, here's what's gonna happen. Kong is gonna say Martha, and then Godzilla's gonna be like, why did you say that name? And they're
Don't
gonna be friends.
joke about that. It's not funny.
I'm just fucking around, dude. I'm
Nah.
just saying though, like, yeah, like they're gonna fight for a little bit and then they're gonna be friends.
Yeah.
Cause yeah, th those are our two boys, man.
I
Those
just
are
remember
Godzilla and Kong.
in the old Kong versus Godzilla movie, I feel like Kong won, but Godzilla was more bad guy back then, I think. It's been a while since I've seen it, like 1962.
I would be curious to rewatch those old like Kong versus Godzilla stuff. Just to see like how those were like, you know?
King Kong lives.
Yeah.
1982.
But yeah, I'm just like super curious about seeing more of these creatures. Which, by the way, there was some of the news headlines at the end were very interesting. They revealed that like Rodan had gone to a volcano in Japan, like near Mount Fuji or whatever. Which apparently, like, that's kind of like where he first appeared, right? Like on one of the mount, like one of the volcanoes in Japan or something. Because obviously these creatures, these things are Japanese. All the Godzilla stuff is Japanese. So that's cool that Rodan went to Japan. And obviously we talked about it already, but there's another Mothra egg, so Mothra's coming back. But yeah, well, you got any?
Oh, I lost my boy again. That
Well,
was
sorry
weird.
about that. Yeah, that was weird. Apologies on my behalf, everybody. I'm back. What I was saying is, any other thoughts? What else? What else? My bad, everybody.
I looked over and saw my own face was like, whoop.
Yeah, my bad, everybody. That was a mistake. So yeah,
It happens.
you got any other thoughts before we like talk about the post-credit scene and stuff like that?
Just that I liked the movie a lot. I thought it was good. And I'm excited for Kong versus Godzilla.
Yeah, I'm excited for that one as well. Especially again, like after rewatching all these movies, it was I'm looking forward to the
I
next one.
thought the CGI looked really good. I don't think we mentioned it, but they're giant fucking monsters fighting.
Yeah, I mean again, all the monster stuff was handled like
Oh yeah.
very, very
It's the
well.
human side we hate.
Yeah,
And it's a very small part of the
essentially
movie,
the
you know?
human side is the stuff that I don't really necessarily care for.
But that's not why I go see Godzilla. I go see Godzilla for Godzilla, so.
Yeah, I want to see Godzilla because I want to see these motherfuckers fight. You know what I
All the
mean?
monster stuff's
That's
good, Mothra's great. I thought at the end, when they're all kind of bowing to Godzilla, I thought he's gonna fucking blast Rodan for what he did to Mothra. Like, we're gonna see it fucking line up. He's just gonna blast him. It
like
doesn't
fuck you for killing
happen.
my girl.
But it doesn't happen. He spares him.
Yeah,
I was like,
he's a
ah. Oh. I was like, I wanted him to blast Rodan, to be honest. I just wanted him to obliterate him because I was like, it's your bad motherfucker,
the king with mercy, yeah.
Godzilla. That's right. But I wanted it just because I thought it had been badass.
Right. Which, by the way, we didn't even talk about like what, like after the nuke, Godzilla got like powered up and shit. Remember when he was fighting?
Yeah, like he went like atomic.
Yeah, dude, that was fucking cool, man. We didn't even talk about that.
He
That was
gets like
awesome.
two power-ups. He's like a fucking Dragon Ball Z character in this movie.
Yeah, man,
Both.
that was rad,
He's like a
dude.
fucking Saiyan. Every time he almost dies, he gets stronger.
Pretty much.
He gets powered up from the nuke, so he starts like glowing. And then he gets hurt. Like, Rodan and Mothra fight, and then Mothra gets hurt, and then she like stings Rodan through the fucking shoulder, which that was badass, by the way. Fucking, yeah. And then Godzilla gets hurt, and Mothra goes down there and like fights off Ghidorah. No, Ghidorah's gotten pushed back a little bit. She's like crawling over on Godzilla, and then like she flies at Ghidorah, and then she gets like obliterated by like a lightning blast thing. But yeah, and then like she heals Godzilla as she dies, if I'm remembering right, and then that powers
Yeah.
him up. But yeah, oh, I did like how smart Ghidorah is. Like if you look at it,
Oh
like you
that was really cool.
like when it bites the power station and gets a fucking power boost from it. Do you remember
Right.
that part? I
Yeah,
like that
I
part.
do.
I
Yeah, no,
thought
yeah,
that part
Ghidorah
was very
was
cool.
yeah, it was, I think it was really smart, yeah.
Yeah. But other than that, like the movie, and yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I
Oh,
enjoyed the movie.
fucking at the end when Godzilla's like got his head in its mouth and it's still alive and it's like fucking drrr, like that, and then he fucking atomic blasts it. That shit. I'm like, I was
I
like,
like
that's
when
so metal.
he just like I like when he would just like bite off fucking Ghidorah's heads, dude.
Yeah, and it fucking grew
Like,
back,
fuck
which,
your
by the
head,
way,
bitch.
that shit was gross.
Yeah, when seeing it grow back.
Yeah, Ghidorah loses a head early in this movie and then grows one back like a fucking Hydra.
Yeah, it's
It
pretty cool though.
was
Which
nasty.
again, Ghidorah's an alien creature from
Yeah.
not from Earth, which most of the other kaijus are. But yeah, let's talk about the post-credit scene here a
Yeah,
little bit.
because that sets up some stuff.
So we got Charles Dance, which, you know, I was wondering before the post-credits, like, what happened to Charles Dance? I was wondering,
I was
right?
wondering if they were gonna kill him or not.
Because I was like, what happened to his character?
The ultimate answer
And
is they
then we
don't.
see him in the post-credit scene purchasing one of Ghidorah's heads.
Yep, one of the, it's rotten too. Like hear fucking flies
Yeah.
buzzing and shit. He's like, we'll take it.
Which I think what they're gonna do is they're gonna do like the oh, fuck it, what are they, the Mecha Ghidorah or whatever?
Yeah, they're gonna do.
How crazy would that be?
That'd be dope. I had that fucking action figure.
Fucking Mecha Ghidorah, dude, that'd be nuts, dude.
I'd be
If they did that.
down. I'd be down.
That'd be pretty
I'm
dope. That'd
down
be
for
cool.
that shit.
Because I know Godzilla has a lot of like Mecha this, Mecha that type thing. Like there's a Mecha
Yeah.
Godzilla. So I'd be interested to see that kind of stuff. But yeah, I thought the post-credit scene was pretty neat. If I remember correctly, that was the only one, right?
Yeah, but they show like a bunch
Didn't
of
have
those
more than
clip
one.
news clippings during the, which are which we
Right.
talked about. But they go by so fast, you
Yeah.
have to like go back and like pause.
And then of course they show at the end of the movie, I think Kong versus Godzilla, right? Like that's the next thing coming
That
up.
pretty much is set up, yeah.
Yeah, they set it up for the
and then
next
it's
one and stuff.
happening, which will be soon.
Which will be next year. Let me see if I can find a release date on that because
I think it's
Godzilla vs. Kong is coming out. Where is the release date? I don't think we have one yet. Do we? Oh, March 13th, 2020.
not that
That's
long.
soon.
Relatively smooth.
October, November,
Which
December,
means we should get a
January,
trailer soon,
March,
I would
February,
think,
March. We're
right?
like 5, 6 months away from it.
I could see like a teaser coming.
Yeah, we'll get a teaser like
It's
I
gonna
don't know,
be like a Rocky movie.
within the next couple months we'll get a teaser, probably.
Yeah. You're just gonna hear a bell ring. Fucking Godzilla and King Kong standing in a boxing ring.
Ding ding ding, you get Michael Buffer. Let's get ready to
They should
rumble.
do that, actually. That'd be dope.
And then Ken Watanabe comes from the dead. Let them fight.
Let them fight.
Let them fight. Which would have been cool if he was still alive, man. To keep him say let him say that again in this next movie, but
Yeah.
killed him. God damn it. Anyway, overall thoughts. So I really enjoy. I like the movie.
I like it.
I just again my problems with these Godzilla with these current MonsterVerse movies with the Godzilla ones is that I don't really necessarily care for the human stuff.
I think they
That's
just need to find they need to
my
find the
biggest issue.
balance. They need to find the
Yeah,
balance of it.
yes, they. I want them to find a balance for the next one because I don't. Human stuff doesn't do it for me, man. It really doesn't. I just want to see these monsters fight each other, dude.
If you're gonna do it and have a bunch of characters as doctors, make them fucking smart. Don't make them stupid. So many characters in this movie are stupid. But like, this is a doctor. This is Dr. Vivian. This is Dr. Sam. Dr. Rick. Dr. Emma, Dr. Mark, they're all stupid, by the way. We're all gonna do all this that's my I just feel like they're dumb. Like all the adult characters besides like the ones I mentioned. Charles Dance, Zhang Ziya, or I don't know how to say your name. I apologize if I'm
Doctor, I
saying it
think
wrong.
Doctor like Doctor Chen, I think was her
Yeah,
name or
Dr.
something.
Chen, the twins. And then Millie Bobby
Yeah.
Brown's characters, they're all fine. They're great, and Ken Watanabe. They're all fine. I just the humans, just a lot of the humans are stupid, and it bothers me. They're supposed to be doctors.
Yeah, I mean, yeah,
Yeah.
that's again, the human characters are the weakest part of the movie for me, for sure. I'm looking at the poster again for this movie. Beautiful.
It's good.
All the marketing for this movie was fantastic. All the posters, I like how like they're different. They're all colored differently for each of the kaiju and stuff. It's just really fucking cool, man. But anyway, yeah. So, in short, we like the movie, but human stuff sucks. Pretty much. That's the gist of it.
Which, even with that sucking, still great movie.
Yeah, I mean, I still enjoyed it. So, you know.
How much money did this movie make? Come on.
Not sure.
I'm
I
curious.
don't. I'm not. I don't know if it did super well. I don't know. I'll be curious.
The budget was 170 to 200. It made 385 million. So it made a profit. Not a big profit, but a profit.
Some, yeah.
I mean, you gotta imagine it's a lot of money to make all that CGI look
Yeah, I
good.
mean, it's a lot. You have to consider like marketing and like all that
And
stuff
you
too,
got like
man.
a bunch of fucking monsters and
Yeah, there's a lot that goes into movies, man. Like, it's fucking crazy. But yeah.
I hope they keep making these movies. I know they're
I hope
expensive,
so
but
too. Like I want again, I don't want any of these movies to be bad. I want them all to be good. I want to keep seeing them be good. And yeah, I just want to see pretty much if you're listening out there, people who make these movies, I just want to see these kaiju fight. Okay? Please. Please listen to
let
Ken
them
Watanabe in
fight.
the
Let
first
them
movie.
fight.
Let them fight. But yeah, I mean, do we have any you want to call it here? You have any closing
I don't
thoughts?
think I got anything else, man. I like it. Good movie.
All right.
Sorry.
No, you're good. You good. I'm looking through my notes here to see if there's anything I wrote down that I
I'm trying
want
to
to talk
think.
about. We talked about Emma already. She was
Okay. I don't
Lots
like
of Kong references. Talk
he's
about the weird ass fortune cookie
a
joke.
villain is a murdering maniac, and I don't care what anybody says.
No, yeah, that's all I got. I think we're good, man. So.
I love Mothra. I don't feel like we gave Mothra enough praise. She's great in this movie.
I like all the. I enjoyed all the main kaiju titans. They were all cool.
I even got interested in the side ones like Behemoth. Like,
Yeah. I just wish we had seen more of them, you know?
yeah.
But because I'm just because I'm like super curious about all of them. Like, I want to see, like, you know, I want to see like a bunch of them, you know? Like, again, I watch these movies for the giant monsters. So
Yeah, they only show
that's
like
what I
the
want to see.
mountain one like one time, and that's because
And
it's
like,
gigantic.
yeah.
They're like 17 and counting. So there's like a bunch
Right.
more that we haven't
There's a
seen.
bunch more that hopefully we get to see at some point. But
And
anyway.
since some of them come from space, like Ghidorah, you got a whole universe just open to make up a bunch.
Right. Right.
If you want to.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, overall, big fan. Big fan.
Yep. Yeah, I like the movie, but again, it's just the human stuff, which we've already mentioned a lot of. So, yeah, I mean, I think we'll probably call it there, huh?
We'll swap over to our shoutouts. How about that?
Alrighty, let's do that.
There you go. Go.
All right. Thank you everybody for joining us today on this episode 14 of Clockwork Cantina Podcast. This is the Godzilla King of the Monsters episode. Yeah, thanks guys. We'll be back again next week. Stay tuned for the topic of next week. Josh will probably tweet it out. I'll put it in my Discord server and in the channel
Yeah, we'll
that's
figure something
appropriate for
out.
this. And yeah, I mean, thank you guys for showing up. As always, if you're listening on YouTube and Google Drive for the MP3 version, thank you, appreciate it. We'll be back next week, of course. And tomorrow, don't forget, we have D&D, Frozen Decimation. We'll be back. I think it's 3 p.m. Pacific, 6 p.m. Eastern.
Yeah.
That's the time. So we'll be back tomorrow, ending the current arc. So, you know, join us because that's gonna be awesome. And as far as my stream stuff, yeah, you can follow me at the appropriate stuff down below. I don't know if it's left or right, whatever. It's there. You see it on screen. I'm playing through Middle Earth: Shadow of Mordor on stream. We're getting close to the end of that, I think. I feel so. We'll be playing more of that on Monday. Come check it out. Come join us. And then we'll probably play another stuff. Like, I want to do like some more Jackbox stuff, like more community-based stuff like that. And hopefully maybe I can re-download Red Dead so Josh and I can play some of that. And, we'll see.
Yeah.
But yeah, thank you guys. We'll be back, you know, and we'll be seeing you around. So bye-bye. Thank you all, everybody.
All right, we're gonna flip over to me real quick. Howdy, friends. I think I'm on me. Yeah, I'm on me. Howdy, y'all. Thank you everybody for watching the Clockwork Cantina, or listening if you're listening to the MP3 version. We appreciate your love and support every week here. The Cantina is every Saturday at 3 p.m. on twitch.tv/josh92, so make sure to come see us live. That way you can talk in the chat and give us info just in case we're missing anything. Coming up tomorrow, we have D&D, as Daniel mentioned, 6 p.m. Eastern Time, 3 p.m. Pacific. Pacific, not specific. tomorrow, so that's Sunday, September 15th. If you're here, don't go anywhere, because I think we're gonna stream some Borderlands after this, some Borderlands. So I'm gonna what'll happen is I'll take the stream offline and then restart it. That way I can save the VOD for Clockwork Cantina to Twitch, and I can also go ahead and make the MP3, and I'll be uploading that. It'll be up probably within 45 minutes to an hour, probably not even that long to be honest with you, probably shorter than that. So if you want an MP3 version, that'll be there. Appreciate your love and support, guys. Make sure to come by next Saturday, September 20, 21st, Saturday, for the next Clockwork Cantina. And coming up on the stream this week, we'll be playing some Borderlands 3, because I bought it last night. Because I said, fuck it, I'm going to treat myself and have some fun. And keep an eye out, I'll probably be doing some D&D streams as well. I have a new world that's coming along, and I kind of want to stream my process for world building. At the same time, I don't, just in case my players watch it. So I'd have to be like, if you're somebody that might be a player in my game, don't watch this stream. But yeah. Anyways, guys, thank you for the love and support, and we'll see you next week or in right after this. You're hanging around for. Bye-bye, guys.